welcome you to the Steve Coach Cady Arena at the Goggett Ice Center on a Friday night for some Miami hockey on Red Hawk Radio. The Red Hawks hosting the St. Cloud State Huskies this weekend, the final home weekend series of the 2019 calendar year. Alongside Luke West Poley, I'm Patrick Geshan. Luke, it was 365 days ago today that I visited a school called St. Cloud State to look at their broadcasting program. And on a Friday night in St. Cloud on December 6th, I watched a Husky team that was then ranked number one in the country beat the Omaha Mavericks by a score of 2-0. But they're not number one in the country right now. They are struggling on the year, only two wins overall. And the St. Cloud State Huskies are trying to find something, and it's almost getting to be too late.
Yeah, you know, I think, you know, when you get towards this halfway point in the year, this is a, you know, time where you really need to put together a run, especially if you start off the season so slowly as St. Cloud has. And, you know, when you're a school like St. Cloud, you have such high expectations for your team every single year, year in, year out. As you mentioned, they were number one in the country last year and, you know, weren't able to make a ton of noise in the NCAA tournament last year. And so they're hoping to turn that around this year. Not a great start for them, but they've got a really big series here against Miami in conference play on the road. And, you know, if they can come out with points this weekend, that'd be huge moving forward.
The RedHawks coming off a sweep last weekend at UConn, 6-4 the score on Friday, 4-3 the loss on Saturday. St. Cloud was idle last weekend. They're coming off, though, two weekends ago, a sweep at North Dakota. Our national anthem coming up, and then our puck drop. Miami and St. Cloud State a little over 2 minutes away from puck drop. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Here's our national anthem.
Last week, he was a familiar presence of all Miami athletic events and was a retired professor of marketing. He was known for his love of teaching, emphasis on student learning, innovation in undergraduate education, and mentoring junior faculty. We'd like to keep the entire Giver family in our hearts and prayers. And let us now join in a moment of silence. Thank you. And now please remain standing and join in the Pledge of the National Anthem performed tonight by the Miami Hockey Band.
National anthem tonight, courtesy of the Band of Brotherhood. Miami Hockey Pep Band playing the national anthem tonight. It's a very light crowd at the Goggett Ice Center in Oxford. The student section only about half full. The general admittance only about a third of the way full. Hopefully some people will fill in at the Goggett Ice Center here as we await this 7 o'clock puck drop tonight. Well, if you listen to the Miami starting lineup, you probably heard that number 36, Grant Valentine, will be the starter tonight out of Medina, Ohio, making his second start of the year. The junior started last a few weeks ago at Omaha, coming in an 0-0-1 record, 3.02 goals against average, .868 save percentage on the season for the Miami RedHawks. The St. Cloud State Huskies, it's David Rennick, number 34. It seems like he's been playing with St. Cloud for about 10 years now. LA Kings draft pick, a 3.22 goals against average, .881 save percentage, a 2-6-4 record on the year for him and the struggling St. Cloud State Huskies this year. NCHC series tonight, so our referees are Scott Bocall and Ian Kropp. Brett Gullick, John Filo are the linesmen. As St. Cloud State wearing their away black jerseys, they have white numbers, white names, a stripe down each side with a red stripe followed by a black stripe and then a white stripe. RedHawks are in their home white uniforms with red shoulders, red letters, red names, red pants, and red socks. So we're set, ready to go here for some college hockey action tonight as the Miami RedHawks battle the St. Cloud State Huskies. And the faceoff at center ice is won back by the struggling Huskies. They get it up to the far side of the ice, and it's tipped into the far corner by Jack Paling, the assistant captain, starting on left wing for St. Cloud tonight. Hawks are able to work it out right away. Ben Lowne chips it forward for Karch Bachman up the right wing over the Husky line. Gets the puck behind the net, a center feed in front. Phil Nye's tripped up before he could catch it. But no call, the puck back to the near half wall. Bachman hits the brakes, near hash marks along the half board. Gets it for Ben Lowne. Pass to the right point. Jack Clement, a wrister in wide. Jack Geshan behind the St. Cloud net will play it to the near side for Paling. And then it's Kevin Fitzgerald trying to work it out, but RedHawks keep it at the left point. Derek Gashke fires it in, and 40 seconds in, Miami will get their first five-man change of the night. St. Cloud State, a pass up the near wing. It's tipped into the zone by Nick Paling, the brother of Jack. And Ryan Paling, you may have heard, playing in the American Hockey League right now, was a senior last year at St. Cloud State. All three of them are brothers. Puck now loose and neutralized. Andrew Sedard plays it back to the RedHawks end. Behind the network, Russell. Hit there by Walker. Puck back to the near half wall. Chase Plutsky trying to play it out and wraps it around the boards to the far half wall, the defensive zone for Miami. But St. Cloud there to take it away at the near corner with Sam Hentges. Gets it a turnover here as Casey Gillick stole the puck. And then St. Cloud State a cycle down low. At the left point, a shot in there. Missed wide by Andre Treball. St. Cloud now will get it up the near half wall. Sam Hentges plays it back to the near corner. Pinched up against the boards, Nolan Walker, the sophomore of Anchorage, Alaska. Plays to the far side for Johnny Brodzinski. He'll ride Andrew Sedard to the far corner. Puck now loose in front. St. Cloud State trying to get a shot off. Hedges was tripped up, trying to skate through the slot to the near side. Rock's got the puck away. Rook Russell off feet ahead. It's a breakaway. Gordy Green in on goal! And he shot it off the top right corner of the net. Hit the crossbar. Gordy Green got a feed from Rook Russell. Caught it at the Husky line and walked right in all alone on Rennick, who didn't touch the puck, but Green missed it off the top right corner of the net. Up the wing, St. Cloud State, stuffed in from center ice by Zach Okabe, the freshman of Okotoks, Alberta. Puck to the near half wall in the Miami defensive zone. Jack Mahalik behind the RedHawks net will tip it to the far corner. Scott Corbett there will find Sladek up the right wing half wall, but it's stolen away by the Huskies. As tipping that away was Chase Brand, their freshman. Takes it behind the net, he'll walk it up the half wall. Tipped away though by Ryan Savage, who plays the puck indirectly to Corbett, left wing neutral ice. And the Rocks are over the Husky line here and a little rush the other way, but Corbett will play it behind the Husky net where it's picked up by Brendan Bushy. Back behind the net, Luke Jacobs will pick it up for the Huskies. Up the left wing, a pass stretching it out to Okabe at the right wing neutral ice. And Okabe there was unable to touch it. On the offensive side of the Husky line, it's an icing, 17:20 left to go in the first period is our first stoppage of the game.
Yeah, good chances there for both teams in the early goings. There's a shot in from St. Cloud. You see them with that low zone cycle, able to get it up to the point for a tip shot. Save was made by Valentine. Then Gordy Green got a nice feed from the defensive zone. Was able to go in a breakaway, but just rung that one off the crossbar. So good chances for both teams to start this one off.
Huskies with a draw in the defensive zone, and they play it all the way back down the ice for an icing up the left wing again as Jaycox handled it off the draw. Trying to get it out through high glass. With 17:13 to go here in this first period. Well, last week, Luke, the defensive zone was the biggest struggle for the RedHawks, and we'll see how they handle that here this week.
Absolutely, you know, adjustment's a big key for the RedHawks, especially coming off being swept last week on the road at UConn.
Was not a good weekend last weekend for Miami. They really didn't play a lot. They play well in majority of the time that weekend. As St. Cloud State will ice the puck again from the left faceoff circle of the defensive zone. Jaycox with the exact same play, trying to feed it up the middle all the way down the ice. A St. Cloud State team that's struggling this year because they graduated a lot of seniors from last year. Those are the likes of Ryan Paling and all kinds of guys. Jimmy Schultz as well, the all-time defensive point scorer for St. Cloud State. Graduated last year as well. Rocks with the puck in neutral ice. Karch Bachman on the right wing will play it back to this defense. And Bray Crowder here will stop it and circle around neutral ice and play it to the near side for Rourke Russell. Russell will circle back behind the goal line of the Miami defensive end. Long stretch pass tipped into the Husky line by Karch Bachman into the St. Cloud zone. Jack Geshan will grab a near corner where it's pinched up by Phil Nye. Trying to feed Ben Lowne to the near circle, but St. Cloud State gets it back up ice. 2-on-2 coming the other way. Nick Paling was swiped away there by Crowder in the neutral zone and will retreat to dump it in behind the Miami net. Valentine out to stop it. Rick Russell will pass to the far side. It's break. Crowder skating up the ice, feeds Ben Lowen a neutral ice, and he dumps it in from the red line right wing. Rocks with a five-man change here, and St. Cloud State will pick it up on the right side and try to feed it ahead. Tipped into the zone by Nick Paling on the near side. As Rocks moving right to left across your radio in this period, St. Cloud left to right. Alec Mahalik will feed Andrew Sidard. Left wing on neutral ice will dump it behind the St. Cloud net. Huskies here will play it up the near board. Sidard, though, keeps it in at the left point for the RedHawks. And it's Nolan Walker who circles back in the high slot. Huskies end to play it up the right wing neutral ice where it's tipped in by Johnny Brodzinski. Back to the far side. Mahalik plays it up the far half wall. Trable. Get up behind the net. Nolan Walker picks up the cycle here but runs into the referee far corner. And that allows Casey Gilling to take the puck for the RedHawks, but he'll lose it to Brodzinski trying to wrap it around to the near boards. Brodzinski back to the near corner. Sam Hetches trying to work it free on Casey Gilling. Picked up by Walker, far corner, feeds Hetches. Walking up the far half wall, trying to leave it for the D-man there. That was Trayball with a puck back to center. And Gordy Green will take it over the Husky line left wing. It's a top of the circle, taken away by Hetches. Pletsky picks up the puck near circle. Walks it behind the St. Cloud neck, dodges a hit. And takes it to the far corner where he's locked up there with Trayball. Puck wraps around to the near half wall. Derek Daschke plays it behind the net to the far corner. The puck is loose. Jack Clement pitches in from the right point to grab it. And will take it now as a defenseman behind the St. Cloud net. Daschke top left circle. Got a feed. A shot in. Deflected off his skate to the far half wall. Corbett will grab the puck there in the far corner. Trying to pass it up on the wing for Clement. But Walker came in to intercept it. Now the puck loose in the high slot. Still in the offensive zone. Redhawks get it back. Right point Clement. To the left side for Daschke. Waits. Back to the right side. Clement with a feed to the slot. Slide it. Can't get a shot off there. And it goes to the far corner. We're behind the net. Ryan Savage will pick up a St. Cloud pass and feed to the slot for Sladek's shot. Went off the blocker of Rennick. Corbett walks up the near half wall. St. Cloud staying able to get it out. It's Brodzinski. Reaches the red line to dump it in. And Valentine behind the Miami net to play it. Jack Levent will skate it up the right wing out of the RedHawks zone. They play it back to the near side. And all the way down the ice, it's going to be an icing call on the RedHawks here. As Sladek trying to pass it cross ice from behind the red line. That's going to be an icing, and with 14-10 to go in the first, Rocks lead the shots 1-0.
Yeah, I got the first shot. It was just a feed into the slot, and it went off the blocker of David Rennick, but a really good offensive shift there for the RedHawks.
Offensive zone draw for the Huskies. Far circle of the offensive zone. Coming up through the near corner, it's Jamie Cornelia. Lost the puck, though, in the offensive end for St. Cloud. They got it back in very high slot. It's controlled here by Okabe. Feeds left circle. Coming in for a wrister there from the far end was Luke Jaycox. Saved by Valentine. They pick it up far half wall. A shot in from the line. Okabe deflected again to the far half wall off the pads of Valentine. Jack Clement picks it up there. Plays it behind the Red Hawk net. Daschke wraps it all the way around the boards and all the way down the ice. The St. Cloud State didn't play it, and it will be another icing call here with 13:36 to go. In period number one, shots now one apiece.
And the RedHawks really need to get off the ice. As I mentioned, they had that offensive shift a little while ago with a lot of zone time, and this group's still out after two straight icings. Obviously, you're not going to use your timeout this early in the game, but they really need to just get this puck out.
Shot for the top of the far circle by St. Cloud off the draw. Micah Miller ripped it high off the glass, and it went back to neutral ice. Jack is shot in the RedHawks end, or the Huskies end rather, will play it off the right wing, and it's tipped in by Jake Wall and number 21 in black. Miami trying to get it out the far half wall. Brian Hawkinson kicks at the puck in a battle. St. Cloud takes over high in the zone. A feed to the left side out of the reach of a shot who chases it to the far corner. Gets it back to the near side. Wall and Miller trying to slap it from the high slot, but it went wide on Valentine. St. Cloud gets it back far corner. They feed it to the left point. A shot. Wrist her in, bounced wide of the net. Miller was there for a tip in front, but directed it wide. Noah Jordan near half wall, feeds it behind the net, and Rourke Russell will stop here and calm things down for the RedHawks. Russell up the near boards, plays it off. Noah Jordan at the red line left wing for the RedHawks will chip it into the zone. Stopped by St. Cloud, but Nyes gets it at the top of the near circle. Makes a spin move, a weak shot in on David Rennick. He will make the save, and we'll get a timeout here, our first of the game. 12:39 to go, first period, Miami and St. Cloud scoreless from Oxford. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 12:39 to go in the first period. Miami and St. Cloud are tied at zero here. Faceoff is coming to the near circle of the Miami offensive zone. Ben Loud is going to take it for the RedHawks. He will square off here against St. Cloud State's Kevin Fitzgerald. And we get a whistle here for a false start of the draw. RedHawks will have Loud kicked out, and Phil Nyes will step in and take it. A loss for Phil Nyes. St. Cloud State wins it back. They hit it to the far half wall of the defensive zone. Brake Crowder cops the puck down there, but stolen away by Jack Paling. He takes it behind the net and plays it to the near side for Meyer. Chips it off high glass to the line. Nick Paling gloves it down there. Plays it cross ice to the Red Hawks zone. Crowder flips it out far side. A bouncing puck over a few sticks at center. And back to pick it up in his own end. Spencer Meyer for St. Cloud State. Feed to the near side, Nick Paling. Fitzgerald over the line right wing. Feeds to the near circle. Circling back there is Jack Paling to feed to the right point. Meyer is shot. That one just wide right of the net. Valentine was screened pretty good there. Red Hawks got a break. Phil Nyes will cop the puck up to the near side. Fitzgerald rifles it in down the near half wall. That's stolen away by Bray Crowder. Plays it off the far boards for Phil Nyes and a rush the other way. Gilling over the middle of the blue line to the near circle. A backhand shot in. Rebound in front of Reddick. Right there was Kurt Bachman to pick it up, but St. Cloud will clear it before he could get to the puck. All the way back in his own end to pick it up. Alec Mahalik feeds to the near side. Capstick. Pick it up here, left wing, Gordy Green. The Karch Bachman over the Husky line. Skates it down to the near circle. Feed in front for Green, who tipped the puck to the far corner. Jack Ashon picked it up there, and then Green got a stick on it. Now a two-on-two battle in the far corner. Bucksworth's free to the far circle. Scott Purvix will grab it for St. Cloud. Sam Hedges leads the rush the other way. Feed over the left wing, Brodzinski. Cuts toward the middle, trying to go for a centering pass, but ticked off by Gilling, trying to feed Green left wing a neutral ice. It goes all the way down. I missed him for an icing call here. As both teams, Luke, trying to get the puck up ice via the stretch pass, but it's not working tonight for either team.
Yeah, both teams really trying to, you know, get that transition game going. We've seen both teams trying to stretch the ice out a little bit. We've already seen Gordy Green get a breakaway off a stretch pass earlier in this one. St. Cloud doing it as well, but neither team able to punch one in yet.
Faceoff here will be to the left of Grant Valentine. Taking it from Miami, Casey Gilling will win the draw back. Alec Mahalik plays it to the far boards. Gordy Green there will golf it back to center, and St. Cloud State will take over. On the left wing in their own end, Brandon Bushy. A pass tipped in at center ice. This will be no icing. Behind the net, Alec Capstick plays it to the near boards. Chase Pletsky will pick it up and fire it back to center. Coming in from the near side, Bushy will play this one into the zone, and it went off the netting out of play. Referee didn't see it for a little bit, and a kind of a delayed whistle there as Bushy picked up the puck. Right wing at the red line for St. Cloud State, trying to dump it in. It was too high and off the netting. So the faceoff here will be at neutral ice, near side. Ryan Savage will take it for Miami. Will Hammer for St. Cloud State. Clean win for Savage, back to the right point as Clement, the right defenseman, chips it out to center ice. The Rocks here will rush down the far wing with a puck. Is behind the net, played here by Clark Custer for St. Cloud State. His first touch of the game. Got it to the far half wall. Hammer will golf it back to center, and Derek Dashke, the only one there for the Redhawks to play the puck. Gets it to the right wing. Jack Lamette, cross ice feed. Savage picks it up at the Husky line, walks in the zone, cuts in your circle for a shot deflected over the right corner of the net past Rennick. Crowder behind the net for Corbett. Walks it up the near wing for the Redhawks. Scott Corbett back to the left point. Dashke slides it across the right side. Clement the wrister in. Rennick didn't see it. And he's lucky he got his body in front of that. Caught it while standing up and then went straight down. With a puck in the breadbasket. 10:06 to go in the first period. Kind of a scary one there. The Redhawks lead the shots 5-2.
Yeah, and I think St. Cloud really has done a poor job in this start of the game clearing out the front of the net. Redhawks have really had a lot of opportunities on tips and rebounds. Rennick's been sharp so far, but definitely an adjustment the Huskies need to make moving forward. And on the flip side, I think the Redhawks have done a good job getting traffic in front of Rennick and developed a few pretty good chances so far in the front of that net.
Face off here in the far circle, Redhawks offensive zone. Playing behind the net here for Monty Graham, who missed that. And up the right wing, St. Cloud State will clear it back to center. Tipped in, here's Okabe over the line left wing. Lost in the far circle, will regain control of the puck. And a backhand feed here to the near corner. As Rourke Russell trying to pitch the man up against the boards. Okeby gets it back far half wall. Plays it to the line. They slide it across to the right point. Meyer able to kick it into the zone. Soccer style to the near circle. Brodzinski feeds the line. Trimble slap pass down low. Got deflected to the near side. Now a shot in front. Deflected off the stick of Cronilla. And that went straight to the ice into the far side. St. Cloud gets it back. Good puck movement in the offensive zone here. Back to the near corner. It's Chase Brand trying to play the puck, but a feed up high get picked off here by Noah Jordan, who hits the red line right wing and dumps it in for the Redhawks. Behind the St. Cloud net, Reddick will play it to the far corner. Meyer trying to dodge the forecheckers and will feed this one up through center, but it missed everybody. And Alec Kapsik will pick it up in the circle and fire it off high glass far side into the St. Cloud net. Bachman down the left wing, pitching in, trying to grab the puck. Jack Poehling behind the net for Meyer. Little backhand play to the far corner for Poehling. Loud coming in, though, wreaking havoc. It's St. Cloud State having trouble getting it out as Nick Poehling will skate up the left wing and feed his brother Jack. Jack down the left wing, fired a shot over the net on Grant Valentine in the offensive zone. Burvick's played it in from the right point in front. Rocks take it over there. Phil Nye's at the left wing, out of the Miami zone, back to center. We'll play this one weakly in before the red line. Jack Geshan picks it up near corner of the St. Cloud net. Skates it to the far half wall via behind the net. Jack Geshan now will take it out of the St. Cloud net all by himself and feed it to the right wing. Nick Poehling to Jack Poehling. Feeds it off his brother's skate in front of the net. And here comes the Redhawks back the other way. Gordy Gray got a pass on the left wing over the Husky line. Plays it behind the net for Dashke. Rifles it off the boards. And the end boards there. Chase Pletsky behind the net, and now let's get it to the far corner and cycle it for Gordy Green. Green having trouble, feeds Pletsky behind the net, up to the left point, Dashke slides it across the right wing. Clement, high slot, Pletsky can't catch the pass, slightly behind him. St. Cloud State weakly gets it back to center ice, but Jack Clement right there to rifle it right back in the zone. Gordy Green gets Pletsky on the left wing, a pass behind the net, hard off the stick of Casey Gilling, who lost it to the near half wall and will regain control. Plays it to the near side for Gordy Green, pinched up against the boards there. And a 2-on-2 battle now in the near corner of the Miami offensive zone. Gilling will play this one behind the net. Picked up by Sam Hedges, the Minnesota Wild draft pick. Can't clear up the near half wall. Dashke to the left point. Gordy Green will play it behind the Husky net to the far side. Bushy far corner. Will Kidd try to clear this one up, but can't. And now St. Cloud State will get it out on the right wing. Brodzinski feed at center. Walker over the line left wing. Drops it for the trailer. Hedges circles back at the line. Feed to the right point. Meyer reaches the right circle. Walks it to the corner. Plays it off the side of the net. You try to center it in front. Redhawks take it there and play it out on the right wing. Brodzinski chases the puck back to the Husky end. Off the boards to center ice. Crowder feeds it across ice over the line. Corbett left side. Plays it to the near circle. Nobody could pick it up for Miami. Trammell grabs it for St. Cloud. And a backhand feed up the near half wall. Walker chips it back to center and beyond. As JC get all the way down the ice work. Russell, the puck about 7 feet in front of him. He will watch it become an icing here with 6:48 to go in the first. Shots are 5-2 still in favor of Miami. Faceoff coming to the left wing of their offensive zone. It will be Monty Graham to take it. He'll score off with Sam Hedges, and St. Cloud wins it to the near corner of the off of the defensive zone, rather, but Redhawks will keep it in for a second. The St. Cloud gets it back. Brodzinski over the line left wing, tried to do that, but instead Bray Crowder got a stick check there to knock the puck behind him. Brodzinski tried to re-enter the zone, but the men on the rush were offside. They entered before the puck did, and it brings us to another timeout. 6:36 to go in period number one. Miami at St. Cloud are scoreless in Oxford, and it's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. face off in neutral ice. Far side, RedHawks toward their defensive zone. It's a clear win for Ryan Savage, who gets it back to the RedHawks end. Break Rauner plays it up the right wing, tipped in by John Sladek. Far side at the red line. Sladek gets the puck far half wall after a St. Cloud field clearing attempt. Hits the brakes in the far corner, walks it up toward the point. Was pinched off there by Bushy, who tried to get it ahead to Brand, but the RedHawks pick off that attempt and throw it back behind the Husky net. Luke Jaycock's off high glass, the near boards, out of his own end, up the right wing, here comes the Huskies. Brand, top of the near circle, fires a shot, low on Valentine, big rebound in front. Coming in there to get a second opportunity was Okapi, but Valentine made the save with his pads. Buck now gets the far half wall, the St. Cloud offensive zone, a two-on-two battle. Savage and Russell are in there. The puck is lodged between the boards and Savage is skating. Savage will work it free and get it back to center ice. Up the left wing, Sladek can't get a pass indirectly to him and neutralized. It's St. Cloud State regroups to their own end. Perbix, D&D pass, far side up the left wing, it's a shot. Reached center ice and they gave it back for Perbix. Now at the near wing, it's Wallen to dump it in off the backhand into the Miami zone. Ben Loud will pick it up behind the RedHawks net. A strong forecheck here by the Huskies. Will Hammer will play it to the far circle as St. Cloud sets up in the offensive zone. It's back to the left point for a shot. Shot in, bouncing all sorts of directions, just wide on Valentine on the right side. Back to the near corner, Miller, pinched up with Siddard. Gets it behind the net for Wallen. Crowder lays him out behind the net, but Wallen able to get it to the left point. A shot to the right side, Purvix. Fires a shot purposely wide behind the net. Rocks play it to the near half wall. Boppin trying to take the pitching wedge and get it out, but Purvix blocked it. And now Ben Lowne and Karch Bachman are battling there at the near boards of the RedHawks zone, and they play it behind the net where Crowder will get it off very high glass all the way down the right wing. But an easy call here for the officials. They say icing with 4:44 to go in the first. Well, these two teams, the last time they met was back in March in St. Cloud, Minnesota. And that was the first round of the NCHC playoffs. St. Cloud State sweeping the RedHawks, Luke. And that was how last season ended for the RedHawks.
Yeah, and that's how the tenure of Rico Blasi here ended for Miami, beginning a new era here. And Chris Bergeron and looking to get some revenge on their former foes last year in St. Cloud State.
RedHawks hit it up the right wing, neutral ice, popping over the Husky line, stops far circle, feeds it back for Phil Nyes, played it on Redick, but patted to the far corner as Nyes re-picks up the puck. Gets it to the right point for Clement, slides it left side, Dashke is shot in off the stick of Bachman to the far corner before it reached the cage. Up the far wing, it is Jack Paling. He lost it at the red line, and Huskies get it out of the near side. It's Fitzgerald, top of the near circle. A wrist shot there off the far post, and the rebound play just wide on Ballantyne. What a rip there, but St. Cloud State hitting the iron for the first time tonight. Ballantyne was really beat on that wrist shot. Puck back to the Husky at Jack Paling near side. Plays it to center ice to Nick Paling. Circles back into the Husky end again. Now a feed to the near side. It is Clark Custer up the right wing. Reaches the red line, dumps it into the near corner of the Miami zone. Custer trying to chip it past Jack Clement. Doesn't work. Back to the near half wall. Huskies keep it in right point. Jaycocks trying to get it deeper off the stick of Gilling and back to center. As the Huskies back in over the line on a rush the other way. Up the left wing, Walker trying to get an angle to the net. Instead, Dashke poke checked it to the far corner. Sam Henches picks it up here for St. Cloud State. Walked it up the far wing. Brodzinski takes over. A shot off the shin pads of Clement, who gets a change as the puck back to center. Custer feeds it to the circle. Jimmy Walker played it to the right wing. Jaycocks will dump it in from there. Far corner, Monty Graham, RedHawks end will shovel it behind the net for Kapsik. Looks at it to the near side for Derek Tashke. Puck back to center, off the stick of Green, right back to the Huskies. Henches over the line in the middle of the ice. Cuts to the left wing, takes a 360 in the circle, but a feed to the slot picked off by Green. Back to the left wing, Monty Grant plays it in from the red line just in time for no icing. Behind the Husky net, Geshan will skate it up the left wing at the half wall and play it back behind the Husky net for Purvix as the RedHawks change and then begin to forecheck. Purvix feeds it up through center, a seam open up and a breakaway for Cronilla. In on goal and he scores! Jack Cronilla got a feed, a neutral ice. He broke away with speed, a backhanded shot went under the right pad of Grant Valentine. It was up in the air as he was in a butterfly. Left it just about an inch off the ice. The puck slid right under that. And with 2:41 to go in the first period, the St. Cloud State Huskies lead it by a score of 1-0.
Yeah, and it's just a breakdown for the RedHawks. St. Cloud's behind their own net. We're getting ready to break out of the zone. The RedHawks try and lock the wings down and move everybody towards both of the outsides of the ice. And that just opened up the whole middle. Cronilla was wide open. They stretched it out to him. He goes in on a breakaway and puts it past Grant Valentine, and the Huskies up 1-0 here early.
Yami Cronilla out of Nokia, Finland. One of the many European players on this Husky roster. Sink Love Sink gets it back to the left point of the offensive zone. Trable played it behind the net. Squirts to the near half wall where it's picked up by Miller. He's pitched up against the boards by Savage at the near side for St. Cloud State. Scott Corbett out of the zone for a second. And St. Cloud got it back in off the stick of Mahalik. Savage back at center trying to regain control of the puck. And we're going to get a penalty here. Savage went in on contact there with Micah Miller. And Savage sticking his knee out. Miller's okay, skating back to the far bench. But Ryan Savage here will get himself a two-minute minor. And it's going to be for tripping. With 2:07 to go in the first period. We got a timeout. First power play of the game coming St. Cloud State's way. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Seven left to go in the first period. St. Cloud State about to hit the power play. As they lead it 1-0 here, a faceoff coming in the near circle to the left of Grant Valentine. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here from Oxford, Ohio tonight. And a faceoff win for Miami, who clears it out of the zone. And Jack Geshan will grab it here for St. Cloud State in his own end. Ashaw, the captain, feeds it to the left wing for the assistant captain. That's Nick Paling. We'll walk it into the zone left wing, and St. Cloud will set up. Jack Ashaw at the blue line, feeds it far circle. That's Spencer Meyer. Circles back at the far half wall, back to the line for Ashaw. Near side, Hedges, back to the near circle. A lot of puck movement on this power play for St. Cloud State. Nick Paling trying to feed the right point, but it came out of the zone, and Ashaw back to grab it at center. He's quarterbacking the Husky power play right now. It's got 1:15 left in it. Hedges over the line right wing. Makes a move in the slot. Has a break to the net, but can never get the puck on his stick for a clean shot. Puck back to the near corner. Red Hawks defensive zone. Jack Clement has it. A feed right in front of the net. Meyer, the shot off the right shoulder of Clement, or Valentine, rather. Now a shot top of the near circle. A feed down low. Nick Paling patted away there by Valentine. Back to the left point of shot. Feeds it right side. Hedges picks it up right circle. Gets it back to the top of the line. Ashaw walks it toward the right wing. Down low for Brodzinski and back to the line for Ashaw. Walks it down the near half wall. Back for Brodzinski. Stick handles top of the near circle. Back to the line for Hedges. Brodzinski right point. Walks it in. Feed to the far side. Missed Ashaw. He picks it up far half wall. And back to the line Hedges. Fakes a slap shot. Far circle Ashaw. Makes a toe drag shot. Save. Rebound in front. Valentine got his pad on that one, too, off the stick of a shot. 30 seconds to go in the period, 20 in the power play. Hedges far corner for Brodzinski. Walks, waits to the top of the blue line. It was Meyer back for Hedges. Winds up for a slapper off the stick of Nick Paling, who chases it to the near corner. Paling back down to the corner. Brodzinski, 12 in the period, feeds it in front. One time for Meyer, patted away Valentine. He makes another shot on a rebound from Brodzinski. Redhawks can't clear it, though, up the right wing. It's Sean. Able to shovel it back in the zone. Redhawks back to full strike. 1 second to go. They have a 2-on-0. But the whistle will, or the horn will sound before Ryan Savage can get a shot off here. As the Redhawks now getting involved in some extracurriculars in the far corner of the offensive zone. Ryan Savage came out of the box with about 9 seconds to go in the first period. Redhawks had the puck right where he came out. He had a 2-on-0 the other way with Karch Bachman, but as soon as they really got control of the puck, there was 2 seconds to go. And couldn't make do at the time.
Yeah, it took the Redhawks a couple tries to try and, you know, clear that one out and get one that past Jack Ashaw, who was on the point for the Huskies, and when they finally did, there just wasn't enough time for them to go in on the breakaway. And for St. Cloud, I think you really got to be happy with that period. They had all kinds of offense, especially on that power play. While they weren't able to score, I think they had a really, really positive power play in terms of just getting all kinds of chances. I mean, Grant Valentine did a fantastic job on that power play and keeping the puck out of the net. But St. Cloud really doing a lot of good things on offense right now, and they have the lead going into the first intermission.
St. Cloud leads the shots 11-6. They lead the score 1-0. Bardowski, the podcast coming up here in the first intermission. We'll take a quick break and be back with you. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio.
Teddy Bear Toss going here in the first intermission, and we welcome you into our first ever live recording of Bardowski the Podcast with Patty and Luke here. First intermission, St. Cloud State up on the Miami RedHawks 1-0. And Patrick, we saw St. Cloud team, as you mentioned, come into this game. They struggled a little bit early in this season, a season that, you know, maybe had some mixed expectations with a lot of seniors graduating off a really good St. Cloud team last year. But they looked really, really sharp in that first period.
I really like, Luke, how St. Cloud State in the power play in the last sequence, they were really, the puck movement wasn't really there, but instead everybody was moving around the ice. All the players were moving around a lot. That's what I really liked out of the St. Cloud State team. As they were confusing the RedHawks, they were unable to get in passing lanes. Miami was never fully able to set up on the penalty kill because St. Cloud was moving around the zone so well, with bodies going everywhere, switching spots, feeding the puck, drop passes, whatever. That's what I really liked about St. Cloud. The other thing is the quality of their scoring chances are much better than the quality of Miami's scoring chances. They're getting shots off the post. They're finding open lanes to get shots off. And the RedHawks defensive zone, I feel like, has been a little bit better tonight, Luke, than we saw last weekend at UConn. But still, they're allowing St. Cloud State to get plenty of opportunities off the rush, plenty of opportunities when they have set up in the offensive zone.
Yeah, you already mentioned that series at UConn. You mentioned this penalty kill a little bit. The RedHawks kind of just looked all over the place there on the first one. I think with the Huskies, you know, just flipping the ice so often, it just seemed the RedHawks got to chasing a little bit. And as a result, we saw a lot of opportunities for the Huskies. And you mentioned that UConn series earlier. What do the RedHawks need to do here? I mean, that series against UConn was very, very forgettable for the RedHawks. Definitely not their best series of the year, maybe even their worst series they've had all year. And you know, what do you do now here? You're down 1-0 in the game. You're coming off a, you know, series like that. What do you do kind of moving forward where, you know, you're able to generate positive energy for your team?
You got to have someone in the locker room, Luke, not a coach, not a staff member, but a player that fires up the team. And that's got to come from your captain, Gordon Green. It's got to come from a senior like Phil Nyes. It's got to come from your D-Core, who's trying to get back into it. And, you know, I think, Luke, the coaches can yell at the players all they want and can try to pump up the players all they want and be positive with the players all they want. But you've got to have someone in that room, a player, that fires up your team. And Miami has seen that in previous, you know, teams. Steven Spinell, a good example, a good defensive captain a few years ago. If you go back 10 years ago, a guy like Ryan Jones, if you remember back that far. Andy Mealy was really vocal in the room. Guys like that who will fire up the team. And when you're a player and you see another player on the team, maybe older than you, maybe more experienced than you, maybe getting more playing time than you, leading the team, being a vocal leader, trying to fire you up, that makes you want to play better. And I feel like for Miami, you got to have someone other than a coach try to pump you up. Because I heard Chris Bergeron's pregame speech to the team before the game, Luke. It got me fired up, and I'm not even playing tonight. And so, you know, if I was a hockey team, after I heard that, I feel like I'd play a little bit more spark in the first period than the RedHawks had, you know, in that first. Not that they were terrible, but I feel like we could see more spark from the RedHawks here after the first 20.
Absolutely, and I definitely agree with you on that. You know, this game could absolutely be 3-4-0 at this point with the scoring chances that St. Cloud has generated, not exclusively credited to, you know, Miami's poor play in the defensive zone, but also some good things on the St. Cloud side as well. So we're going to switch gears to the NHL here like we usually do, and we got some interesting teams atop Their divisions in the Eastern Conference. We see teams like the Islanders, the Flyers, the Panthers, the Sabres. I mean, what are these teams doing, you know, in playoff spots in their division? We're not used to seeing these teams, you know, this far up here. Is there anything, you know, that you're seeing that's just different to you than in years past as to why maybe we're seeing some of these teams have more success than we're used to?
Well, I think, first of all, Florida's acquisitions of the offseason, not only Sergei Bobrovsky, but also Joe Quenneville are really helping. I think Joe Quenneville is such a good hockey coach, and he finds ways to motivate a Florida team that really doesn't have a whole lot of big names. It's not that talented when you look at it down the roster. And I think you can really give their credit to being second in the Atlantic to Joe Quenneville. I think Buffalo's a really good story too, Luke. A team that's just struggled so much the past few years. They haven't been able to make the playoffs. They're in a really tough market to have that kind of success. We had Kevin Adams on in intermission a series ago, and he was talking about how he really liked how his team's veterans were coming together, and he liked how all the young stars were starting to play as well with maturity, like Jack Eichel. So I think that's huge for Buffalo as well. I think they're finally able to get the culture turned around there, and you're kind of rooting for them here coming down the stretch. They had a bad loss in Calgary last night, but I think, Luke, those are the two biggest surprises for me so far in the Eastern Conference.
And in the West, we're seeing the Arizona Coyotes and the Edmonton Oilers, also both teams that really, you know, haven't seen a lot of success. The Oilers, I mean, they've just been fantastic on offense this year. But the Arizona Coyotes are atop the Pacific Division right now and just playing really, really well.
Well, you got to credit Phil Kessel, obviously. They picked him up. That's a huge acquisition. The coaching change there really helped as well. I'll be honest, I haven't really watched Arizona a lot this year, but a team that certainly added players to their core that have helped a lot, and I think you got to credit their offseason acquisitions. Kessel, the biggest one, obviously, that's really helping them out this year as they now lead the Pacific Division over two great teams like Edmonton and Vegas. Vegas also kind of making a comeback, too, after they had a pretty bad start to the year. They're kind of finding their stride here as we near kind of the end of the first quarter of the season, I guess, in the NHL.
Absolutely. So some different things we're seeing in the NHL, and it's obviously very exciting to watch some new teams have success, and like the, you know, the Golden Knights, obviously with not a whole lot of history, and the Buffalo Sabres seem like they're back in business to what their old teams have looked like, which is exciting to see for all the Sabres fans out there. So we'd like to thank you for joining us here. It's our first live broadcast. We decided last minute that we're going to try and do this, and we hope that you enjoyed Barnowski, the podcast here. First intermission between St. Cloud and Miami. St. Cloud leads 1-0, the Huskies over the RedHawks. We'll be back in about 8 minutes for the second period for you. This is Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio.
Geshan Loop West Poley back with you here before second period action featuring the St. Cloud State Huskies and the Miami RedHawks. St. Cloud State leads it by a score of 1-0. They lead the shots 11-6. What do you want to see out of this period from Miami, Luke?
Well, I think it just starts off with being a little bit calmer. I think they got a little bit too excited at times in the first period, and as a result, I think St. Cloud was able to take advantage and get them to chase the puck around the zone a little bit and open up some, you know, far side backdoor opportunities, things like that, you know, with some big flip ice passes. So I think that the RedHawks just need to do a better job of just staying calm and relaxed in the defensive zone especially.
All right. Huskies moving right to left across your radio on the second. RedHawks moving left to right. I think St. Cloud State controls the puck in the offensive zone. Far corner, Nick Paling trying to kick it free behind the net. Jack Paling was down there for a pass, but Nick kept it. Skated up to the far point, trying to feed it down low for Purbix. They got upended and now feeds it far corner for Jack Paling. Walks it up the far half wall for St. Cloud State. Backhands it back behind the net for Kevin Fitzgerald, who picks it up. Back to the right point, Purbix slides it across left side. A shot, fired it purposely wide. Dashke picks it up off the boards, plays it far side. RedHawks will break out here. Arch Bachman over the line, left wing for Miami. Gets the offensive zone and now the circle behind the net. He'll take it and up the near half wall now. As Bachman lost it there, Brake Rado played it from the right point over the net. And picking it up on the far side, Nick Paling will feed it back to the far corner for a shot. Backhand feed on the near side, Nick Purbix. Cross ice to right wing. As went off the stick of Nick Paling, a little bit too far in front of him. RedHawks regain control. Casey Gillick feeds it to the near side. Gordon Green will play it off the boards and pick it up in the near corner. As let's go RedHawks to Chan here. Brake Rado, right point, fired a shot in, bounced in front of the net and went behind it. Jack Geshan picks it up near corner here for St. Cloud, feeds Brodzinski and up through center. Over the line for the Huskies comes Nolan Walker. Hits to the far half wall. Rourke Russell pitches him up against the boards. Coming in, Gordon Green. Get it behind the Miami net. Brake Rado will reverse direction of the play to the near side for Pletsky. Although St. Cloud State plays it in from neutral ice, Crowder picks it up in the near corner. Up the right way, Gordon Green tipped it at center ice. And they're going to wave off the icing here, saying St. Cloud State touched it on its way down. Huskies pick it up in their own end. Up the near boards, Brodzinski feeds across ice for Trable. Picked off there by Siddhart. He's over the line left side here for Miami. Siddhart for the corner, trying to center in front, off a stick behind the net. As Sladek there missed the puck, Brodzinski takes over and feeds it back to the near side, Trable. Around the board to the far side, Brodzinski can't clear it. Barely kept in by Siddhart, left wing. Walks it down for a wrist shot over the net. And it went all the way off the glass back to the RedHawks end. Mahalik will chase it and pick up a stop puck from behind the cage by Grant Valentine. RedHawks working up the far boards. Ryan Savage picks it up at center ice. From his knees, will play this one to the end boards and behind the net. And the Huskies here will get it up back to neutral ice and play it up the right wing as it is Zach Okabe. Plays it into the near side, a cross-quarter dump in. Derek Gashke behind the Miami net, plays it to the far boards. Noah Jordan takes over there. Will reverse direction back down low. Dashke a backhand feed the near side. Clement wraps it around the near boards, but picked off by Brand on its way to Sladek. Bushy a shot from the left point, got a feed. He fired off his stick at Clement. It went out of play with 17:07 to go in the second period. St. Cloud State 11-6 leading the shots.
Yeah, we haven't seen any on net here yet in the second period. And not a whole lot of offense thus far, but some good transition games from both teams, just moving the puck up and down the ice.
Face-off win for the Huskies in the offensive zone. Nick Purbix plays it down the right wing to the far corner, picked up there by Brake Crowder. Little backhand feed to the far side, trying to get it out of the zone, but the Huskies keep it in. Crowder pitches up the puck along the end boards behind the Miami net. In a two-on-two battle, there's couple guys in there for St. Cloud. Monty Graham will play it off from the far corner. The Redhawks get it back to center ice. Crowder, the defenseman, leads the rush over the line right side. Chips it in behind the Husky net. Purbix, the first to it, up the far half wall for Walker, who misplayed it and kept it deep by Rourke Russell. Geshan met by Jordan behind the Husky net. They get it up the near boards. Jake Wallen will grab control of the puck and flip it in cross corner for St. Cloud State to the right wing. Picked up by Russell, backhand to the near side. Break Crowder out of his own corner. We'll play this one up the right wing, neutral ice. Vilnius tips it into the Husky end, and St. Cloud State will regroup here. Kevin Fitzgerald, backhand feed to the left wing. Trable up through center, passed it by Nyes to the stick of Russell, waiting now in the far circle defensive zone, but now picked off by the forechecking Fitzgerald, who feeds it up the left wing for Trable. Trable, slap pass down low, went off the end boards. Jack Paley picks it up behind the net and walks it up the near half wall. Switches spots with Trable at the left point. Trable plays it behind the net for Nick Paley. Walks into the far side, a little wraparound play there on Valentine. His pad and stick were there to guard the left post. He's able to make the covers. Work Russell trying to shove a man away from the net. I believe that is Andre Trable. And now a gathering of players behind the net continues. All five RedHawks are down there, and three of the Huskies, the linesmen, will mitigate the situation before anything heated arises with 15:47 to go here in the second. St. Cloud 1, Miami nothing. As the Huskies have won 10 faceoffs, the Redhawks have won 7. 3 block shots for Miami, 2-4 St. Cloud State. 1 penalty in this game, it was to Ryan Savage for 2 minutes. back in the first period. 15:47 to go in the second. Face off to the left of Valentine, and Miami will win this one back in the defensive zone. Al Mahalik plays it to the right wing. Cordy Green to center ice. Across ice feed over the line. Left wing is Casey Gilling for a centering pass in front to a streaking Sinard, but tipped in wide on the net. Behind the Husky net, Pervix will take it out the right circle. Feed it across ice, and here come the Huskies over the line left wing. A backhand feed in front for Walker. Was too far in front of him. A shot came in from the far half wall from Brodzinski. Covered up there by Valentine with 15:22 to go in the second. Well, for a St. Cloud State team that has been idle last weekend and got swept pretty bad in North Dakota a couple weeks ago, November 22nd and 23rd, haven't really come out rusty tonight. I think Clown's been on it so far. And that's the kind of style this team has historically played since they joined the NCHC. Rock to win a defensive zone draw. They get it out quickly. Ryan Savage over the line left wing for Miami. He's got a 2-against-4 rush with Corbett. Savage takes it behind the net. Shoved down from behind. We'll get a penalty on that as Custer was behind Savage, riding him from the far circle all the way behind the net. Cross-checking Miner coming here to Custer. He upended Savage kind of from behind. Right behind the Husky cage. And cross-checking Miner coming here to Custer. It will be power play number one of the night for the Redhawks.
Yeah, and a big power play here from Miami. Once again, they're yet to get a shot here in the second. And it was a little bit, you know, pretty far into the first that you'd have to go back to find where they got their last shot. So looking to generate some more offensive opportunities here and a great opportunity on a power play.
They went it back to the right point. Derek Daschke to the far side. Cordy Green, far circle, fed it to the far corner. Phil Nye's off the left boards. Plays it to the left point, Daschke. Crossed the right point, Gilling. Walks it down to the circle. Returns for Daschke at the line. High slot, far circle. Green, fan on a slap shot. And back to the far corner, the puck goes. Green against the boards. Pinched up with Savage. St. Cloud trying to clear it. Can't get it past Daschke, left point. Slides across right side for Gilling, a shot. Hung there in the slot for a second, bouncing around. St. Cloud able to clear. And Gilling trying to play it in from the right point again. Got blocked down back to center. Daschke in his own end will grab it for Miami. 1:22 to go on the power play. Cordy Green lost it coming up through center. Jack Paling feeds to the near side for Nick Paling over the line left wing. Reaches the circle. A shot came in for a shot. That deflected off a few bodies, and Nick Paling will take it to the far corner of the St. Cloud end. Redhawks will grab it behind their net. Good penalty kill there for St. Cloud. The penalty kill work, I should say, as the Redhawks over the line left wing now with a minute to go on the power play. Cordy Green plays it behind the Miami net. Phil Nyes golfs it back to the right point. Casey Gilling pitched up against the boards. He's forced out back to center by Hammer. And Redhawks back in their own net here. Gilling will get it back up through the center circle all alone over the line right side. One against two, feeds it to the left wing for Cordy Green. Circles back top of the far circle. Green will stop. He gets it to the right point for Gilling. Back for Green. Walks it into the circle. High slot. Daschke a drive. Blocked down in front to the near corner. Gilling here. One against two battle along the near boards. 25 to go on the power play. Now Savage comes in to join the party. So does Nyes. Nyes works it free. It gets it to the right point for Daschke. Walks the line to the right circle. Now Gilling. Stick handling. Walks it down low along the half wall. Back for Daschke at the line. Far side for Cordy Green. Hits the brakes and then returns it back down low. Green still with the puck to the far corner for Savage. Power play winding down, 3 seconds to go in it. Green up the far half wall to the circle, now high slot, still with the puck on the forehand, right circle. Green will go behind the net, feed it in front. Nyes was on his knees, can't get a shot off. Still loose in the crease, St. Cloud State though, able to take it to the safety of the near corner. Jaycox was hit hard by Green. Puck up in the air, back to the line. Crowder will play it in for the Redhawks momentarily, although taken back by Custer, fresh out of the box, who feeds it to the left wing for Fitzgerald. Over the line all alone, will feed a wrister in on Valentine, who makes the cover here, and we'll get a timeout. With 12:36 to go in the second period, Miami power play unable to produce a goal. St. Cloud State still leads it 1-0. Here it's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Faceoff will come to the right of Grant Valentine in the Miami defensive zone with 12:36 to go in the second period. Ben Loud will take the draw against Sam Hedges, and the RedHawks here will win it back. And skated up the right wing, Bray Carotta reaches center ice, feed is a cross ice for Ben Loud. Chips it in over the Husky line, and he walks it to the far corner of the offensive zone. Back behind the net, Phil Nice plays it to the far wing. Rourke Russell on it for the RedHawks. It's chipped back behind the net to the near side where it's picked up there by Trable. And up the near wing, Brodzinski will chip this one back out. Sam Hedges at center, plays it over the line right wing. Rourke Russell will grab it in the far corner, RedHawks defensive zone. Back to the near side, Crowder. Left wing, Russell feeds Loun, high slot. Back to the left wing for Karch Bachman, who's over the Husky line, back behind the net. Buck squirts free to the near half wall. Walker picks it up, off high glass, back to center. Glove down by Crowder at the red line, but quickly stolen away. Hedges tripped up over the line left wing, no call though. And Russell back for it here, and the RedHawks behind the net, but Hench is forechecking. RedHawks with trouble getting it out, and they finally do up the right wing. Hawkins in back to center, bouncing puck grabbed by Jaycox, skating backwards, can't give it to one of his teammates, and Rourke Russell played from center ice down the right wing into the offensive zone. Hawkins in there, trying to get it deep along the near half wall, back to the right point, Russell. Played it for Graham, top of the near circle, St. Cloud steals it off his stick, and they're up the other way on a rush. Cross-corner dump it from the far side. That was Zach Olkeby. Back to the near corner. The Huskies grab the puck. And up the near board to the left point. Shoveled back in by Olkeby. Hawkinson will leave it back for Rourke Russell. Chips it back to center. Graham at the red line. Left it for Hawkinson, who dumps it in off the end boards. And St. Cloud State here will try to grab it. But no one shorter with a good forecheck here from Miami. It's played up to the far corner. Pushy up for Olkeby. Left point is killing, plays it off the end boards. Here's Noah Jordan, near corner of the Miami offensive zone. Stolen away though by Okabe, who's up the right half wall and gets it back to center. Alec Mahalik chips it to the far side. Siddard crosses ice feed, tipped off the stick of Green. Casey Gilling near boards for Siddard, center circle, over the line left wing. Here comes Pletsky, hits the brakes top of the far circle. Fed it for Mahalik at center ice, but went off his stick. And Casey Gilling now from the right point will play this one deep into the far corner. St. Cloud State will grab it there, all the way down the ice. No ice at call. They say it was tipped by Miami at center. Mahalik will play it right wing of the RedHawks zone, but it's picked off by Bushy at center on a stretch pass. Jack Paling near circle. St. Cloud offensive zone takes it behind the net. Feeds to the right point, Purbix. Waits, fires it down the far half wall. Behind the net, Mahalik will pick it up and wrap it to the near boards. Casey Gilling will play it up the right wing for Green, but a shot picked off that clearing attempt. Back to the near corner, Jack Paling. Behind the net, Nick Paling. Who hits the brakes far corner. He was stripped by Siddard. We'll get a penalty on that. And up the far half wall comes St. Cloud State again. Touched there by Pletsky as they're trying to feed it to the line. Purvix was. And a penalty here will be coming up against Miami with 9:43 to go in the second period. St. Cloud State's going back to the power play. Andrew Siddard is going to sit 2 minutes here. And St. Cloud State leading 1-0. A slashing call. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Minutes 43 seconds left in the second period. Patrick Geshan and Luke Westpoli back with you here at the Goggin Ice Center tonight. St. Cloud State about to hit on the power play. They are 0-1 on the evening as Andrew Siddard, a slashing minor here, will give St. Cloud State another chance of the man advantage, up 1-0. At the right point, Hedges faked the slap shot, passed down low, picked off by Dashke, and it went up in the air for a little bit. Dashke played it with a high stick, they say, and the faceoff will be to the left of Valentine here in the Miami defensive zone. 1:47 to go in the Siddard minor. and I-29 to go in the second period of this Friday night game. Both these teams will meet again tomorrow night. Same time, same place, 7:05 puck drop here on Red Hawk Radio. Jack is on right point, plays it to the far half wall for Hedges. Back down to the far corner for Palin. Behind the net, Brodzinski played it up the left wing. And there to grab for the Red Hawks, Jack Clement, a backhand out of the zone and all the way down the ice. Jack and Sean will pick it up behind the St. Cloud net. He'll reach center ice, feed it left wing, Nick Paling off the boards, all the way back down the ice, to clear deflection. Brodzinski got it back to your circle, but it was taken off his stick. They cleared all the way back down by the Red Hawks. David Reddick leads it behind that for Jack Geshan. Up the left wing and leaves it behind at center ice for Nick Paling, the left defenseman right now. Paling over the line left side, feeds it back for Meyer, back down to the near half wall for Nick Paling, who fed it to center ice, picked up by Brand, center of the ice. As now Meyer near half wall here for St. Cloud State, plays it to the left point. A shot, stick handling to the right side here. It's returned back to a shot middle line, feeds it near circle. Meyer back for a shot. Makes a nice move on Hawkinson at the right point to keep it in the zone. Now a pass to the near side, Hedges. Hedges and a shot, switch sides. Skates it to the far side, plays it in off the half wall and behind the net, Russell. We'll feed this one up through the slot. Monty Graham grabs it there and fires it back down for Miami with 25 to go in the penalty kill. Behind the net, Jack Geshan plays it up the left wing for Brand. Feed to the middle of the ice. It's picked up by the Huskies for a second, but Miami gets it back. Karch Bakka trying to come over the line left wing. As Gordy Green was in the zone, forechecking, couldn't get out soon enough as Bachman played it in. And it was 7:55 to go in the second. 13 seconds are left to the Miami penalty kill here.
Yeah, and it was a lot better of a penalty kill than we saw in the first period. I think the Redhawks have stayed a lot more disciplined as a result. St. Cloud really hasn't gotten too many pucks towards the middle of the ice in the offensive zone.
14-9, the Huskies lead the shots. Puck loose to the center circle, over the line, Brand on the left wing. At the top of the near circle, poke checked away by Gordy Green, and he'll clear. All the way down the right wing for Miami, and that'll end the penalty, and the Redhawks now tonight have killed both St. Cloud man advantages. Tray ball trails the puck, far half wall, St. Cloud end. Redhawks with a strong forecheck here as we're back to 5-on-5. Perbix will chase a loose puck behind the Husky net, played it to the near side. Jack Clement picked off that. Sladek in front for a shot. Gordy Green was trailing through. And it went off his body and never reached the net. Back to the left wing, neutralized. Trable plays it in from the red line behind the Red Hawk net. Jack Clement hit hard down there by Cronilla. And Jack Clement now will work it up the far half wall after dodging that. He got poke check back deep in the zone. Clement will play it out from the left wing, but it will be off a body, I believe, in the St. Cloud bench. And that will stop play for that for a neutralized draw with 7:04 to go here in the second period. Well, Luke, kind of just a so-so period for Miami. They got to get a spark going here.
Yeah, I think they're really just kind of waiting for St. Cloud to come to them. And I think while they've done a good job in the defensive zone, they're not really being as proactive as maybe they need to be, especially, you know, being down a goal.
Yep. St. Cloud stay with a puck in neutral ice after the neutral ice draw win. Luke Jacox played it down the wing left side. And instead, it's going to be an offside here against the Huskies as some men enter the zone on a rush. Kind of a weird play there. Faceoff will be on the right wing for Miami. At neutral ice, Hammer will go against Savage. And the Redhawks here will win it forward. Sladek played it to the left wing. Corbett will dump it in behind the St. Cloud net. In on the forecheck, Savage can't get there before Jacox plays it to the near half wall. Mahalik now pinched up in a battle along the near boards with Will Hammer. As the puck here will try to squirt down to the corner. Savage works it free up through the slot. Played back here by Capstick, who is in the Red Hawk zone. Mahalik will backhand it back for Capstick, who's at the left point, left defensive position. Cross ice feed Sladek. Right wing, gives it from Mahalik over the Husky line. We'll play this one in off the pad of Reddick. It goes to the near corner, picked up by Jacox. Up the near boards and up through center ice. Here comes Wallen over the line left side, reaches the circle, a centering feed in front. A little bit too in front of Micah Miller for him to handle for a shot, but St. Cloud with a puck back up the near half wall. Left point, Fitzgerald off the bench. Walks it down the near corner, centering feet in front. Nobody home for the Huskies. Picked up far side, Nick Paling. Fitzgerald on the puck here, leaves it for Paling behind the net. That's Nick Paling. Near corner, feeds it in front for Jack Paling. A slap shot there was blocked by Sladek, who's slow to get up for Miami. He's limping on one leg. A shot near circle, walks it down low. Can never get a shot off in front, Nick Paling. Popped it up to near corner. Jack Peeling left-pointed try, patted away by Valentine. Savage off the high glass, plays it up to near boards. Jack Peeling hit hard there by Crowder along the boards, but no call. That might have been a boarding. As Corbett now will play this one over the line right wing for Miami, and Perbix behind the Husky net will grab it and wrap it around the near boards for a shot. Getting a pass to neutralize, Jack Peeling over the Husky line left wing. A shot deflects to the far corner. Kevin Fitzgerald there to grab it, trying to shovel it behind the net. Jack Peeling will gain control off the stick of Dashke. To the near circle of Sean, a slap shot wide over the net and right. As Perbix now with a toe drag far circle, feeds to the line of Sean. Walks it toward the left side, in the left circle now. Centering pass across, went over the stick of Nick Paling, who was still able to manage a shot. Patted to the near side by Valentine. Shot came in there by Jack Geshan. Valentine saving that as well. He'll make the cover in front of him with 4:51 to go in the second period. It's St. Cloud 1, Miami nothing. Late second. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. After the timeout, faceoff coming to the right of Grant Valentine with 4:51 to go in the second period. Johnny Brodzinski will be kicked out of the draw here for St. Cloud. Sam Hedges will take it from the left wing. And a clean win for the Redhawks. Derek Dashke wraps it all the way around the boards and out of the zone and back in their own end of play under St. Cloud. Brodzinski chips it out near half wall. Right wing, a neutralized Collette plays it in from the red line, and we will get a whistle here. I guess the Redhawks were offside there. As the puck quickly out of the zone, Clement quickly played it right back in, and Miami didn't get everybody out of the zone, and they didn't hear the referee yelling the offside, so the faceoff coming at neutral ice on the near side here with 4:36 to go in the second.
Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't put this one all the way down and maybe call an intentional offsides on this one, so the Redhawks maybe catch a bit of a break here at the neutral ice draw.
Ben Loud will take it against Yanni Cronilla. Redhawks win it back. Ray Crowder, near side, cross ice for Russell, played it in from the red line. And this will be actually, is this an icing?
I think it hit the netting.
Looked like Russell was at the red line, far side of the ice. And I guess when he was trying to dump it into the Miami offensive zone, it went off his stick and out of play. Kind of lost sight of the puck there. And the faceoff is going to be at center ice with 4:28 to go in the second. We've seen some really weird stoppages tonight. We just don't really know what's going on at some points. Crowder feeds it far side. Work Russell up the wing. Tipped in by Pletsky to the St. Cloud zone. Meeting him there were the Huskies, and they'll regroup it back in their own end. Jack is shot up the left wing. Feeds Brand. Trying to give it off for Okabe on a little give and go, but instead back to the St. Cloud end. The Redhawks dump it, and the Huskies work it out again. Brand center ice up the left wing. Cuts toward the middle, over the line. Stolen away by Gilling, top of the far circle. Brand gets it back and feeds it to the near wing, but Cronulla didn't get the pass. He'll regain control of the puck up to the left point of Sean. A shot patted away by Valentine. Puck back to the far half wall. Casey Gilling trying to pitch it up with Purvix, but Gilling will get control. Feed across ice and up the right wing. Pletsky trying to make a move. He did over the middle of the blue line now for the Redhawks. Feeds it right side for Gordy Green. Wraps it behind the net. Huskies trying to clear. It's picked off. A Holick drive from the line over the net and way over the net. Gordy Green along the near boards, pitched in with Perbix. Ben Loud and Jack Geshan both join the party. And a little battle here along the near boards with 3:20 to go in the second. Loud kicks the puck free, squirts up the near half wall. Bachman with it for Miami. Backhand shovel at the line for Green, again near half wall. Green a backhand play to the left point. Siddharth trying to feed it back for Green. Came out of the zone at the point. And Pervix here will grab it for St. Cloud to dump it in. They'll get a change here. A full five-man with a puck behind the Miami net. Siddharth up the right wing. Tipped in by Ben Loun. It will come on net for St. Cloud. Gloved up there by David Raddick. 2:56 left in the second. Ben Loun back in the lineup this week after an extended absence with a lower body injury. He was skating a little bit last weekend at UConn, but back in the lineup for the first time tonight in a little bit. And what do you think of his play so far?
Well, I think he's been pretty good. I think that he's been aggressive, especially on the forecheck, which is something that the Redhawks definitely need moving forward with a little bit of a burst of energy. And Ben Loun, that's the type of player he is, and I think they really need him in a game like this.
Redhawks will lose the draw. The offensive zone to the left of Reddick. St. Cloud, though, trouble getting it out. Miami with a good job. The offensive zone keeping the puck in. Jaycock's over the line, right wing for St. Cloud. Feeds to the middle. Fitzgerald, a backhand shot. Valentine got a glove on it, deflected it behind the Miami net. Jack Bailey has it stolen away behind the Redhawks cage by Clement. He's up the right wing. Feeds Savage middle of the ice. He's ripped up. Both arms go up. And chasing it down the left wing is Scott Corbett. He can't win a race, though, to the puck with Brendan Bushy. Nevertheless, power play coming here to the Redhawks. It's going to be a tripping minor against St. Cloud State. And with 2:27 to go here in the second, Miami will go to the power play for the second time tonight. Andre Tremel will pick up two for tripping. So a Miami power play coming into this game. They've scored in six of the last seven games of the power play, and in those last seven games have been 34.8% on the power play. Before that, they're only 3-for-31 for 9.7% in scoring just three of their first eight games. And they've had a power play goal in six of the last seven, and the power play has been hot as of late. St. Cloud State clears it, though, off the opening draw. Derek Daschke to the right wing now. Casey Gilling over the line. Skates it down to the near circle. Backhand feed to the right point. Wide open Daschke. Walks it to the middle. Our side feed for Savage. Down the far half wall. Reaches the far circle. Ryan Savage now will wait here and feed it back to the left point. Gilling walks it down the far half wall. Will protect the puck far corner. Cordy Green now with it. Left point Daschke. Right point Gilling again. Down to the right circle. Walks it down to the corner, behind the net. Casey Gilling still the puck, taking a tour. Back to the line for Daschke. He's the only one at the blue line now. Feeds it to the near circle for Phil Nice. Nice stick handling around, has room. Back to the right point, Gilling. Top of the line, Daschke. Far side here for Green. Hits the brakes at the blue line, back to the circle. Gets it down low, Gilling with the puck, right circle. Playing a shot in front, loose in the crease. Redhawks trying to work at it. Redick out of position. Phil Nice, though, shot it right off his pads. Miami keeps it in left point, Daschke. To the right side for Gilling. Down to the circle, back for Daschke at the line. Wrist shot in, we get a whistle before any of that. We got another penalty coming up here. It's going to be interference. And Phil Nice is going to be whistled in front of the net. And that'll take away the power play here with 48 seconds to go in it. And so we will be 4-on-4 for 48 seconds. It's interference minor against Phil Nice. He must have been really interfering with someone in front of the cage.
Yeah, that's really costly for the Redhawks because I think that they were really starting to find a bit of a rhythm there on the power play, and they were able to generate some scoring chances. They really just had a lot of chances in front of the net, and the puck was just, you know, kind of sitting there in the crease with bodies flying all over the place. And I think that's kind of what the Redhawks need right now if they're able to put that puck in the net. But now they're going to be more focused on here, you know, playing 4-on-4 and skating the puck a little bit more and then killing off that penalty when it becomes time to do so.
Phil Nice on the second line playing right wing tonight. So that wipes out the power play chance for the Redhawks for 4-on-4 for 40 seconds. Pervix over the Redhawk line, left wing, reaches the circle, cut toward the middle. Run the far side, a slap shot there by Cornilla. Went into the breadbasket of Grant Valentine. And that will stop the clock with 1:02 to go here in the second. St. Cloud State, the 1-0 lead faceoff. Will cut to the left of Grant Valentine here.
Yeah, Cornilla already has a goal in the game. The freshman from Nokia, Finland. And that was a ripper. You could see the stick flex from here, but Valentine's able to stay strong. And we're going to get another draw here.
Casey Gilling will take it for Miami. He'll square up with Fitzgerald. Clean win for St. Cloud back to the right point. Pervix down the far half wall. Paley will play it to Bushy, middle of the blue line. Walks it toward the left side. Trying to fire it in, but an off the stick out of play high in the zone. So 52.8 seconds now left in the second, 25 to go in 4-on-4. And after that, St. Cloud State will have about a minute 10 power play with Nyes in the box for that interference minor. Face off to the right of Grant Valentine. Casey Gilling will score off with Fitzgerald. This one went to the near half wall by St. Cloud. Rocks quickly take over. They try to get it out up the far boards, but kept it at the right point there by Meyer. Walking it up the half wall, Jack Paling. He had nowhere to go with the puck. Instead, gets it back to center. Feed to the near side, a shot. Over the line, left wing Fitzgerald. The puck played behind him off the stick of Sinard. St. Cloud State trying to re-enter, but they're offside as Jack Paling didn't quite read the play well enough. He didn't know Fitzgerald was going to take it back out of the zone. Face off here, neutralized with 34 seconds left in the second. It's on the right wing for Miami, the left wing for St. Cloud. Sam Hedges will take it for the Huskies, Monty Grant for the Redhawks. Clean win for St. Cloud, back for Jack Geshan, the lone defenseman in the formation. Shot up through center ice, gave it off over the line, right wing Hedges. Plays it behind the net, indirectly for Brodzinski, who's at the left wing and in the corner. Clement angles him to the boards in a battle here along the near side with 15 to go in the period. Hedges emerges with a puck, plays it back high slot, a shot, a rip, blocked down by Graham in front. He will clear it softly back to center. St. Cloud will send a shot back to grab it with 5 to go in the period. As now a power play for the Huskies. Over the line, left wing, Brodzinski back for Meyer at the buzzer, top of the near circle. And that won the play here in the first 40 minutes. St. Cloud State still leading the score, 1-0, no goals in that second period for either team. And the Huskies carry over a power play for 45 seconds into the third period, Luke.
Yeah, I think that St. Cloud wasn't able to generate quite the offense that they had in the first period, especially on that power play, and obviously they didn't come out with a goal. I think Miami played a little bit better on the defensive side of things, but I don't think they really did a whole lot of what they wanted on offense, and you know, the little bit that they did was wiped out by that Phil Nyes penalty late in the period. So I think that the Redhawks really here down a goal just need to focus on being more proactive in the offensive zone and trying to, you know, create chances for themselves. Somebody's got to step up and, you know, start making some big plays to just reinvigorate this team, because right now it just seems like they are waiting for St. Cloud to make the play and then reacting to it. And, you know, St. Cloud's, you know, any really team in, at the college level is just too skilled for you to just wait and react to what they do. They're not going to score that way. So the Redhawks really just need somebody to invigorate some energy into them in the third.
I want to ask you real quick, how do you think Grant Valentine has played tonight? Obviously just his second start of the year, third appearance of the year. What do you make of his play so far through 40 minutes?
Well, I think he's been pretty good, and especially in terms of, you know, just straight up making saves. I think that at points he hasn't been as sharp. We've seen, you know, some shots go in. You know, we saw a shot earlier in the first period go off a post. He got beat on that, just a clean shot in, no screens or anything like that. A couple shots in the second period kind of, you know, going off, you know, there was one back there that went off his catcher glove. He wasn't able to hold on. It went behind the net. So I don't think he's really paid the price too much yet. I think the, you know, the breakaway goal was definitely not his fault. I mean, no one there to
that
cover
was,
it.
That was a lapse in the Redhawks' defensive coverage.
Yeah, I mean, just no one there to cover the breakaway. But I think he's been sharp and just staying in position and making the saves. But just a little small details, maybe some nerves getting to him a little bit here, you know, and just getting those small things fixed up as it is, you know, only a second career start. So just getting those things cleaned up, and I think he's been pretty good so far.
All right. So we'll have about a 13.5-minute break here before our third period call. It's a close one at Oxford. St. Cloud State 1, Miami nothing. Hope you'll join us for the third period in 13.5 minutes. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio.
Thank you.
Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley back with you here in period number three, about to get it away here from the Goggin Ice Center in Oxford. We welcome you back into the broadcast booth. 1-0, the St. Cloud State Huskies lead it, and the visiting team from St. Cloud, Minnesota will begin this third period with a 45-second power play. And it was a Phil Nye's interference minor toward the end of last period that is giving the Huskies the power play here, but the Rocks win the center ice try, get a demon to the St. Cloud end as Ben Loud skated it in and chipped it forward. Nick Paling behind the Husky net's gonna grab the puck, but then lost it. There is a lot of water down there, and the puck never moved, so Loud picked it up. Dashke back behind the net for Ben Loud. Again, all this shorthanded in the Husky zone. Near corner, Bachman steals it away from Hedges. Bachman will skate it up the far half wall, and he's just going to skate it all the way back down to the red hot can to give it for Dashke. Down to 13 seconds to go on the power play. Dashke rips it all the way down the ice. St. Cloud State again having trouble. It's Monty Graham down there working on the forecheck. Redhawks with a great sequence here in the first 45 seconds to kill off the rest of the penalty. Nick Paling here, far corner of the St. Cloud zone. Cross-ice feed, Brodzinski over the line right wing. He's a far side, Hedges backhands it in on Valentine, patted away. Monty Graham up the right wing for Miami. He's pitched up with Okabe. And the puck squirts free there as Gordon Green will golf this one back to center, and then St. Cloud will dump it right back in, cross corner from the left wing. Up to near half wall, let's work Russell to play the puck for Miami. Russell, cross ice feed, hit Karch Bachman in from the St. Cloud bench, far side of the ice, backhands it all the way around the boards to the near side. Mark Russell pitched up by Okabe, now up the right wing, a rush the other way, Brand hits the top of the circle, feeds it in front for a centering pass, tipped into the pads of Valentine from Yanni Cronilla. Mark Russell is a hit along the far half wall. Chase Brand was on the puck, he got upended. The Rocks here will work it back up the right wing, up through center ice. Karch Bachman over the line right side. Makes a move in on the circle, backhand drive to the net, they score! Casey Gilling picked up the puck at the left side of the crease and backhanded it over David Reddick, who was on his side. 18:08 to go in the third period, and this game is tied from Oxford 1-1.
Well, this all starts off with Karch Bachman. He takes this one into the zone. He pulls a fantastic move right along the goal line to just cut this one towards the net. Rennick made the initial save. Bachman didn't really have too much of a lane, but it was banged in on the back door by Casey Gilling. As we see it again here on the video board in Oxford, it just comes towards the back side. And there was a St. Cloud player down in the crease that might have impeded Rennick coming across a little bit. And they dropped the puck here. The Redhawks with a big goal there, and they tie this one.
1-1 your score. This Miami team has come out in this third period with fire. Derek Dashke near corner of the Redhawks end. Will center a pass for Jack Clement, who's up the right wing through neutral ice. Chips it into the Husky end and behind their net. First to get it, Brendan Bushy. Pass to the near side, and he'll work it under the zone. A stick handling his way up through the ice was Kevin Fitzgerald. Redhawks get it back in their own end. Play it over the line left wing. Here's Corbett. Copped it up in the circle offensive zone. Jack Paley picks it up here for the Huskies. High off the glass. That was a sand wedge, not the nine iron. As it's back to the Redhawk end, Derek Dashke will grab it here for the Redhawks. Backhand feed to the near side. Monty Graham grabbed it. Goes cross ice over the line right wing. Hawkins it down to the circle. A rip wide over Rennick. As Russell plays it in from the left point. Bouncing puck. Nobody can calm it down. Corbett races to keep it in at the right side for the Redhawks. Back to center it goes. Brick Crowder dumps it in. Corbett's going to have to tag up. Miami will get an offensive change here. Defense stays out there, and Russell will play it back behind the Husky net. To the far side, Loud pinching in. Bushy was able to grab it for a second. Gave it off for Henches. Walker up the left wing of neutral ice. Stolen away by Slatic. And they reverse the play. Nyes over the line right wing. Hits the brakes, top of the far circle. Played it back toward the middle, and Slatic here will pick it up the bouncing puck behind the Husky net. Loud wraps it around to the left point, but pass for Russell, who was there to catch the pass. He chases it back to the Miami end and will backhand it behind the net to the far corner for Bray Crowder, who's met with adversity as Brodzinski upends him, and St. Cloud here with a strong forecheck will be able to keep it in the zone on a second clearing attempt from Crowder. Crowder now will get the puck back up through center ice, dumps it in cross corner from the right wing. Meyer will pick it up left corner for St. Cloud State, up the near boards for Miller. Cross-ice feed over to the left wing now with Sean over the Red Hawk line. Opened up there for a centering pass, patted away by Valentine and went on net. Red Hawks get it back to center ice. They throw it in the circle. Casey Gilling chases a loose puck in front of the Miami bench. Transitions to skate backwards and will fire to the left wing for Sedard, who dumps it into the Huskies zone from the red line. Back to the far corner. Casey Gilling trying to chip it past to Sean. Instead picked up here by the Huskies and they'll get it out. They're up the left wing. Red line will dump it in. It went off a skate to the near corner. Sedard first to it. A backhand feed behind the net into the far corner. Mahalik played it off the boards and hit Casey Gilling, but coming in there to wreak some havoc was Jake Wallen. He kept it in for a second, then back to the stick of Gilling, who's up the right wing through neutral ice. Casey Gilling around the boards to the near side. Karch Bachman meets it at the hash marks, and then we'll give it back for Mahalik with a backhand here to keep it in at the left point. St. Cloud takes over there. Up the right wing, neutral ice. Okabe plays it in over the line, right in on net. A little bouncing puck there on the ice was gloved up by Grant Ballantyne. We'll make the cover with 15:13 to go in the third period, a tie game from Oxford.
Yeah, the Redhawks have really come out just really well in this third period.
I'd say.
Down a goal. I mean, that forecheck on that penalty kill to start the period just really started everything off. I mean, St. Cloud almost never really exited their zone the entire almost minute that was left on the Redhawk penalty, and then they're able to get a quick goal after that. They're going to see if they can keep this momentum going here.
Jack Lynn wraps the puck around the board to defensive zone win to the far side for Brian Hawkinson. He got stopped at the Red Hawk line trying to get it back to center. He would, but Huskies get it right back in over the line right wing. Okabe plays it deep behind the Miami net to the far corner. Stopped there by Yami Kurnila. Back to the left point for Luke J. Cox. Back to the far corner. Playing it is Brand. Shovels it behind the net. An extended cycle there. Meeting it up the near boards is Corbett. Coming in, Custer able to keep it deep for the Huskies. And at the right point, kept in by Kurnila for a second. It went off his stick. And Corbett works it back to center. Grant finds Hawkinson. He's got room middle of the ice. Over the line right wing. A wrist shot in from high in the zone. Gloved down by David Reddick. And we'll get our first media timeout of the third period. 14 and a half to go in it. Miami 1, St. Cloud 1 on the Red Hawks goal. And we'll be back to Oxford in a moment. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Faceoff coming to the left of David Reddick in the St. Cloud defensive end with 14 and a half minutes to go here in the third period. We're tied at one here from Oxford. St. Cloud to the defensive zone win. They get it up to neutral ice and a Redhawks centering pass picked off. Fitzgerald on the line, left wing, fired a shot. What a save by Valentine. He robbed Fitzgerald point blank in the far circle. Valentine outstretched the left pad. They got the glove above it to make the save in midair with 14:19 to go in the third period.
Yeah, Brady Crowder falls to start this whole sequence off. And then a big shot there. Might have been Brodzinski that had actually Fitzgerald rather. But Valentine was ready.
He's off to his right. St. Cloud wins it offensive zone. A feed in front of the net could not be handled by Jack Paling. Jack Paling in the near corner, offensive zone for St. Cloud. Watts it up the near boards. Passes to the left point for Ashawn. Ashawn off a stick off high glass. And back to the near half wall. Bachman plays it back to center. Sinard chips it over the blue line. And this is going to be an icing here. Wow. Well, number one, I thought Karch Bachman got to the red line when he dumped it in. And number two, Gordy Green was standing on the goal line in the St. Cloud end when that call was made. No comment from Luke Westphal. 13:56 to go in the third. It's a hard job. as Luke nods. Andrew Sedar near corner, Red Hawks with a defensive zone win. Feeds it to the middle for Mahalik up the right wing. Pass Gordy Green, and he touched that one, I guess. They wave off the icing. Rennick out of his net to play it to the far half wall. Green picks it up far corner. Feeds it in front, went off his skate. Dashke picks it up to the blue line on the backhand. Plays it to the far half wall. St. Cloud takes over here. Rush the other way, 3-on-2. Hetches left wing over the line. Reaches the circle, is cuts it toward the middle. High slot, Hetches. Trying to leave it behind him for some reason. Nobody there. 2-on-1 the other way for the Redhawks. Killing it, Dashke. Killing over the line, right wing. Will cut toward the middle. In front, Dashke. What a save by Rennick. He cut across to make it. And we got a penalty coming up here. I think it's not St. Cloud. They're going to pick up Johnny Brodzinski for holding. He circles back after going for a line change. That's Easton Brodzinski with 13:16 to go here in the third period. Redhawks are going to the power play after a 2-on-1 chance. And what a save, Luke, by David Rennick to our left.
Yeah, it was perfectly played by Miami. I think it was a great job. They baited out the defender to play the shot instead of the pass, then pass it right across. And Rennick flailed the leg out and made a fantastic save and kept this game tied. Easton Brodzinski is going to take a penalty on it, but I'm sure that Brett Larson would rather take a penalty than give up a goal. And David Rennick with a huge, huge save there for the Huskies.
Easton Brodzinski out of Blaine, Minnesota. Rocks on the power play again. They're 0-for-2 tonight. Ray Crowder keeps it in right point after an offensive zone draw win. Left point, Russell back to the right side. Crowder returns to Russell, middle blue line. Near circle, slot it back for Russell. High slot, a drive in front, loose. St. Cloud clears it on the backhand. A diving attempt to keep it in by Crowder, but it went over his stick. And Nick Paling races to the loose puck to get it deep into the Redhawks end. Behind the network, Russell comes out of the Miami end with a puck. Redhawks circle around to the power play. Feeds left wing for Bachman over the Husky line. He's it behind the net for Bushy. He played it off his own man, trying to clear the puck. Huskies, though, will pick up the loose one in the high of the zone. Hawks will circle it quickly back at center. Slatic over the line left wing. He got messed up there in the circle. Hawks trying to play it down that left side. Puck behind the net, picked up by Pletsky. It was loose. To the near corner, Bachman. Hit hard by Jaycox at the boards. Puck came loose. Slatic came in to grab it. And a 2-against-3 battle. The Redhawks will win as Russell at the line will play this one to the right point for Crowder. Back for Russell, middle blue line, near side Slatic gets a pass, has room, fired a shot off the crossbar, out of play. Not Slatic, a point blank chance there. St. Cloud not doing a great job on this kill loop of getting in the shooting lanes. Miami working the puck around pretty well with 54 to go on the power play.
Yeah, and I think they've made that adjustment so far on the power play. I think Rennick's, giving up rebounds, and St. Cloud hasn't done a great job clearing their guys out of the front of the net, so they're really just trying to work the perimeter and get shots in instead of, trying to work those perfect chances, those cross-ice backdoor passes. I think they're just trying to get as many things on net as they can right now.
Face off to the right of Rennick. It's loose right in front. Phil Nye's trying to work it in. It's under the right pad of Rennick. As a win there for St. Cloud. They won the face-off to Rennick's right on net. The puck was loose in the crease for a minute. Phil Nye's came in trying to poke it through, but he was trying to go under the pad of Rennick. It was under his left pad and stayed there until the whistle blew. 12:06 to go in the third period. 50 seconds left in the Miami power play. Tie game at one. Green to the middle of the blue line. Dashke. Far circle. Gilling has room. Walks it down low. Centering pass. Picked off on its way to Savage by St. Cloud, and they'll clear it all the way down. Stopped by Valentine. Leaves it behind his net for Dashke. Up the left wing for Miami. A pass for Gordy Green. Over the red line. Cuts toward the middle. Over the blue line. Feeds it right wing for Gilling. Hit hard as he got it to the far corner. Puck coming in there was Phil Nye's. He got hit too, trying to get the puck. St. Cloud will pick up the loose biscuit and fire it all the way down the left wing. Chris Burns around the Miami bench, trying to get his power play moving here. 13 seconds left in it. Then Redhawks will get a final rush out of their own end. Dashke up the right wing, gives it back for Gordy Green. Up through the center circle. Stick handling over the middle of the blue line. Will go right into the St. Cloud penalty kill box that was collapsing in on him as he went in the zone. And the Huskies get it behind the Redhawks net as the power play expires. Miami power play now 0-for-3 tonight. So Alec Mahalik here will stop behind his own net, feed it right wing for Noah Jordan, who plays it out for Monty Graham. He's up the left wing with room through neutral ice. Over the Husky line, shot from the top of the circle. Big rebound, Jordan picked it up at the corner. Graham came in sliding to take the puck off his stick. Friendly fire for the Redhawks. The puck back to center from St. Cloud. Jordan here in the center circle regains control to right flip back behind the Husky net. Redick stops it there. Pass to the far corner. Played up the boards. Easton Brodzinski got it stolen away near the St. Cloud bench. Two Redhawks came in, but they couldn't quite complete the play as the Huskies over the Redhawk line. Right wing, Cornillo played to the near corner for Okabe. Crowder pitches him against the boards. Far corner wall, and Monty Graham pitches him against the boards. The puck back to center here. Meyer will grab it at the left wing for St. Cloud. Neutral ice and rifle it back in. Puck bounces around near half wall, Red Hawk zone. Back down low. Crowder up the far boards. Can't get it out. Pass Sladek. As Phil Nye's neutral ice plays this one back into the Miami end for some reason. As Crowder behind his own net will try to dodge his St. Cloud forecheck, but it's too strong for just him. And the Red Hawks going to have to regroup. And St. Cloud will get it behind the Miami net. Russell plays it up the near half wall, but definitely not strong enough to get it out. Nice picks up the loose puck, battling with Trable. Nice trying to work it out up the near side. The Trable there with a big body on him will keep this one in the zone. Husky got it in front of the net for a second. Nobody can get a stick on it for a shot. Phil Nye's back the other way. Plays it over the line left wing. Trable in the near corner. Dodges a hit from Russell. St. Cloud able to get this one out. Hammer up the right wing, back for Miller. Hits the red line and dump it in cross corner. Picked up there by Casey Gilling. Will take it behind the Miami net. Reverse direction, a man behind the net. That's Easton Brodzinski in a forecheck. A pretty aggressive one there for St. Cloud. Bachman reaches center, plays it over the Husky line left wing. Down to 9:06 to go in the third period. We're tied at one at Oxford. St. Cloud, the eighth place team in the NCHC. Miami is the fourth place team coming into the night. St. Cloud with the offensive chance here on a rush. Derek Dashke broke it up on the left wing. Redhawks play it back to center. Jack Geshan. Played it from the red line left side. Behind the Miami net for Valentine, who will stop it for Dashke. Hard rip around the near boards. Boppin picked it up at the hatch marks, and he'll try to feed it through the middle out of the zone, but instead picked up by Walker, who plays it in over the line left wing. Geshan fired a rip. Went off of Dashke straight up in the air and off the netting from the far corner with 8:35 to go in the third period. St. Cloud 1, Miami 1. It's time to jump around in Oxford. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio.
Don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot tech the style. I flip the script so they can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every road they trace is a scar they keep. It's when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique. I made my debut in 86 with a melody in a president's mix. And now I stay on target and refuse to miss. And I still make hits for beats. Parties, clubs, and cars and jeeps. My underground sound vibrates the streets. MCs wanna beef, then I play for keeps. When they sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique.
Faceoff coming to the right of Grant Valentine out of the under 10 timeout in the third period. St. Cloud of Miami tied at one. Rocks win the draw the defensive zone, but can't get it out on the far side. Taken here by Alec Mahalik, though high in the zone. He'll get to the red line and dump it in on net. Renick, that kind of make a glove save there and played it behind his cage for St. Cloud to break out. Brand off the end boards, can't get it out. Well, I guess he did. As Mahalik was waiting right there for a judgment call that Brent Golic, the linesman, makes from the other side of the ice. He said it came out of the zone for an offside on the Redhawks with 8:12 to go in the third. Shots are 25-19 in favor of the Huskies. They had a goal in the first. Redhawks had a goal in the third. St. Cloud with a puck center ice, stolen by Miami on the left wing. They get it back to the St. Cloud end where the Huskies regain control. Feed up through the middle. Jack Paling tips it in from the center circle to the near corner of the Miami defensive zone. Mark Russell hard to the end boards, played it right in front of his own net. Ben Lowne will get it to the near side for safety. That's the second time tonight Miami has played it right in front of their own net, the defensive zone. Near corner, St. Cloud has it in their own net. Up to the line, Russell with a shot. Went wide from the left point for the Red Hawks, who try to set up offensively here. Nick Paling, far half wall, walks it back down low in the St. Cloud defensive zone. Behind the net for Meyer near corner. Wraps it up around the near boards. Jack Paling. Pass to the far side. It's played in through the center circle. Picked up here by O'Rourke. Russell is up the left wing for Miami. Cross-corner dump in for him from the red line. Back behind the net. St. Cloud State will play the puck. Nick Purvix kicks it back to the near side. Perch Bachman stolen away with a nice play there. A good effort to give it back for Dashke, who dumps it in from center ice. Wrapped to the near half wall. Picked off by Bachman. Top of the near circle offensive zone. To the slot, Gordy Green. The pass went over a stick. And Brodzinski here, a backhander back to center. Stolen by Purvix up the left wing. Through the circle offensive zone. Got up bended. He'll slide right to Valentine. Valentine is on top of Purvix in the crease. Purvix will exit as the puck up the near half wall for St. Cloud staying in the offensive zone. Jack is shot in the near corner. Hits the brakes. Walks it back up the near half wall. 6:36 to go. Pass to the far circle. Back to the near side. Henches fired it off a stick to the far corner. Brodzinski plays it back down low for a shot. Wraparound drive from behind that. Valentine there was ready for it. Casey Gillick turns it over behind his net to Brodzinski. He walks it to the near corner here, and it's up against some sticks along the near wing as Henches walks it up the near half wall. Pass back for Walker. He trips up. Dashke trips too. A penalty's coming up on Walker. St. Cloud, the touch left point. And I don't know, Luke. I don't think this is a good call, to be honest with you. It's going to be a tripping minor here on the Huskies, as Nolan Walker will go two for tripping. He upended Dashke trying to break out of the Redhawks' end.
Yeah, Dashke just got a little bit tied up with Walker there. And they called the penalty in the zone. It was a bit of a late call, too. So maybe just thinking about it for a second, it was definitely borderline. But deciding to go with the penalty there and a big power play here for the Redhawks. St. Cloud, they kind of closed the shot margin down. St. Cloud's now extended it back out a little bit more. It's 26-19 in favor of the Huskies. And Miami does have some momentum on offense, though. And a power play is a great time to just
for sure
put yourself into the lead.
Yep. Face off to the left of Redick. Redhawks went it to the far corner. Jack Ashon picks it up for St. Cloud State, but can't get it out. Taken over by Pletsky, who's up the far boards. It's taken over here by Jack Paling. Feeds his brother Nick over the line right wing. Shorthander for the Huskies. Trying to fire a shot in from the near circle. That was blocked down by Rourke. Russell takes it to the safety of behind the Miami net. And he's up through the Red Hawks zone and hits the center circle. Russell dumps it in over the Husky line left wing. Took a weird bounce off the glass in front of the Husky net. And the St. Cloud will clear to the near corner. Rucks here left point. Keep it in. Pletsky fires across the ice for Bray Crowder. Down the far half wall. Reaches the circle. Back to the far corner, we'll hit the brakes and circle back. Bounce pass off the boards for Pletsky, right point. Returns for Crowder, middle line Russell, walks in with room. Far circle for Pletsky, back for Crowder, shot in, off his skate early on in the shot. Pletsky grabs it far corner, back to the right point, Russell. He will walk it in, fire a wrister wide on the net. Pletsky again far half full to pick it up with a minute to go on the power play. Right point Crowder, left point Russell, back to the right side for Bray Crowder. Far circle chase Pletsky. Back down low, here's Corbett. Walks it up the far half wall, break Crowder right point. Russell middle of the blue line, here's circle, slide, a good drive, right into the bread basket of Redick. 4:51 to go in the third period, 43 to go in the power play. Good puck movement there from the Redhawks, Luke.
Yeah, just kind of moving it around on kind of that triangle they have set up near the blue line, just with two forwards on each of the wings around the top of the circles, and then one defenseman in the middle, and a shot by Sladek was saved by Renick, but good puck movement resulted in a good shot for the Redhawks.
Up point, Gordon Green can't keep it in the zone. His hammer came in to knock it free. Redhawks regroup at center. They're over the Husky line right wing. Gillick hits the brakes at the half wall. Back to the right point. Dashke plays it to the left point for Gordon Green. 30 to go on the power play. Green near circle. Left point Dashke. Right side Gillick. A wrister in off a skate in front to the far corner, and Miami's going to get a penalty here. Ryan Savage got his stick in on a St. Cloud player going to the far corner. That would be Brendan Bushy. I don't know, Luke. I think that's a makeup call because Bushy barely went down when Savage's stick got in there. They're going to give Savage a hooking call here. And with 4:23 to go in the third period, we'll have 15 seconds of 4-on-4, and then St. Cloud will get their own power play for $1.45.
Yeah, big power play here for the Huskies. Miami wasn't able to convert. I thought St. Cloud did a pretty good job keeping them out of the middle of the ice and just forcing them to the perimeter and just leaving them with some just kind of low percentage shots. But now for St. Cloud, you got a big faceoff here going into this 4-on-4, just trying to move the puck as much as they can and get back to what we saw in the first period on that power play.
Yep. Rocks win the defensive zone draw, and they can't get it out of the zone. St. Cloud, though, will regroup at center. They'll take it out themselves. Cornilla back to the far side here and walking it back behind the Husky net would be Andre Trable. Leaves it for Purbix, who just waits behind Rennick in the Husky cage. Purbix here feeds it to the right wing. Played there over the line by Okwebe. Skates it down the near half wall to the corner. Played up to the right point, Purbix slides it across left side. Given back there from Trable to Purbix on the right point, plays it behind the net to the far side, Okwebe. Taken there by Phil Nizo trying to work it out, but St. Cloud sends reinforcements in. They get it back to the left point. Perfect, top of the air circle, a drive in on Valentine, who makes the save. He came out of his crease there. Right into the breadbasket, the shot went as Perfect's a wide open shot lane from the top of the right circle.
Yeah, Perfect had the shot there through just right in the middle of the ice. He had a clear shot lane. You know, not great defensive play by Miami, but also for St. Cloud, just really not a whole lot of traffic, and that shot right into the breadbasket of Valentine. You know, those aren't going to go in very often. So really for St. Cloud, I think they got to focus on getting some more traffic and, you know, improving those shots when they do have good lanes.
A shot walks the line to the far side for the Huskies. Back to the near wing. Henches from the top of the circle. His stick held by Clement. They didn't call that. Wow. Monogram over the line right away. Redhawks able to clear, though. That's really surprising. 3:10 to go in the third period. 45 left in a St. Cloud power play. Over the line left wing comes Nick Paling. Clement stick check him. Paling forced to play to the near corner of the St. Cloud offensive zone. A little battle here. They get it up to the right point. A shot with room. Trying to pass to the near circle. Brodzinski comps down a bouncing puck. Near side, Hench is walking it down. Dashke got his stick up on him. The puck squirts here to the corner, but Huss can't clear it. A shot kept it at the line. Dodges Cram to the near side. Brodzinski to the middle of shot. That was a rip off the crossbar and out of play. Miami catching a break there. Valentine screen in front of the net. A shot from Easton Brodzinski, very high slot, off the crossbar and out.
Yeah, this all started with Jack Geshan keeping the puck in the zone. He was able to get it over to Easton Brodzinski and a really hard shot off the crossbar. Easton's brother Johnny, who you've accidentally called Easton many times tonight, had a very good shot back when he played college hockey. And he was pretty good in college as well. Easton following in his footsteps here playing for St. Cloud, and he's got a pretty good shot as well. Just showcase that one.
Easton, the 6'2", 205 junior out of Blaine, Minnesota. He played at Green Bay Junior Hockey of the USHL. Rocks went on a defensive zone draw to the right of Valentine, get it back to center. Perfix feeds it to the left wing for a shot. Miami returns. Savage to the ice, so we're back to 5-on-5 here. The power play over, 2:15 is left in the third period. The puck cleared all the way back down the ice. Bachman will beat out the icing here. That was cleared for the Miami goal line. Perfect's far corner, pitches Bachman, who's on all fours against the boards. They're gonna have to blow that dead. As the Redhawks there, Luke on the ice, clearing the puck all the way down as if they were on the penalty kill, and Karch Bachman using his speed, the Florida Panthers draft pick, to beat it out, and the Redhawks here will earn an offensive zone draw with 2:05 to go in the third period.
Yeah, and Bachman was pretty gassed too, I think, after he went all the way down there, just kind of collapsed into the corner. And that resulted in the stoppage and a big faceoff here coming up late in the third for the Redhawks. And it's going to be an offensive zone draw with 2 minutes left.
Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. faceoff coming to the left of David Rennick out of the break. Casey Gilling will take it against Kevin Fitzgerald in the far circle to buy the offensive zone. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley back with you here from Oxford. 1-1 tie between Miami and St. Cloud State. And the Huskies here wrap the puck to the near boards. Nick Paling will get it out to the far side to center ice. And Casey Gilling here will grab it for the Redhawks. Hits and breaks the Miami line. Feeds Cordy Green over the line right side the Husky line. Plays it to the near side. Jack Geshan picks it up near corner for the Huskies. Plays it to Nick Paling near boards. Backed out of the near corner of the St. Cloud end as Miami doing a good job here preventing St. Cloud from getting the puck out. Left point, Dashke keeps it in. Plays it behind the net for Karchbachman. Little between the legs, centering pass taken by Green to the near side. Dashke to the right point, Clement. High shot in, blocked down by Bachman. Far side, St. Cloud will play this one out. Nick Paling got it ahead for Dashke, and St. Cloud here will regroup the neutral ice as Dashke gave it right to him. Nick Paling over the line left wing, behind the net for Fitzgerald, down to 1:10 to go here in the third period. Leaves it back for Brodzinski. Dashke pinches him against the boards. Backhand feed to the line for Jaycock. Slides it across, left side, a shot in wide from Geshan. Brodzinski behind the net will wrap it to the far side as Green chips it back to center. Sam Hench is here for St. Cloud State. Walks it over the Red Hawk line right wing. Down to the near circle. In the slot, Brodzinski fired one off his stick and wide. St. Cloud State here will take the puck out of their own offensive zone. Hedges off the near boards to Dashke near circle. Redhawks in, gave it right back to Hedges. Behind the Miami net to the far corner, Brodzinski. Clement couldn't get to him soon enough. Miller has the puck behind the net. Dashke pitches him against the boards, 30 to go in the third period. Far circle, Brodzinski. Jay Cox, they score! Easton Brodzinski in the far circle, fed it to the near circle for Luke Jay Cox. A shot up high on Grant Valentine. He had not much he can do on that one. It went over his glove. And with 25.2 seconds to go in the third period, the St. Cloud State Huskies have taken a 2-1 lead.
Yeah, and that was a really hard shot there from the point by Jay Cox. Just came right to him, a really quick release. And I mean, initially I thought Valentine made the stick save the way that puck just popped out of the net. Redhawks coaching staff speaking with the officials here about something, but that puck just really came off the back of the net pretty hard.
We're going to get a review here, Luke. Chris Bergeron called the referees over to the bench, and Miami might be challenging something here, and this will get in our announcement. It's come referee Scott Bocall making it. Yeah, Chris Bergeron is pointing to the blue line when he was talking to the referees, and so the Redhawks are going to challenge this here for offside. And we have no access to a monitor up at our booth, so we don't know what is coming here. But Barry Schutte, who runs the defense for Miami, was standing on the blue line behind the bench when St. Cloud entered the zone, and he was the one that told Chris Bergeron to challenge it for an offside. So Bergeron called the referees over and told him to take a look.
Yeah, and this serves a double purpose here. I think if you're the Redhawks, you might have just called your timeout here anyway. So
yeah.
I think that this, you know, is just basically a timeout. You know, maybe if you can get the goal waved off, that's a bonus for the Redhawks. Yeah, like you said, we're not quite sure whether or not, you know, this actually was offsides or not, which way this one's going to go. But if the Redhawks do go down a goal here, Barry Schutte drawn up a play on the whiteboard. You gotta imagine that's probably a situation if this goal is not waved off.
So the referee's in the penalty box looking at it now. As 25.2 seconds are left to go here in the third period. Well, it was a really good shot that came in there from Luke Jaycox, number 6 for the Huskies. Playing on the third defensive pair with Brendan Bushy tonight, the 6'3", 195 junior is Luke Jaycox out of War Road, Minnesota. Played his USHL hockey at Lincoln, Nebraska. And this one might be closer than we maybe anticipated, Luke, as the referee is still taking a look at this one.
Yeah, there's a referee and a linesman in the box right now, both looking. Man. We can't see a whole bunch of what they're looking at, but what we can see, both the guys pointing at the screen, where that blue line is. And it's been a pretty long review already, so obviously a close play at the line there.
Right.
And remember, as you've probably heard, if you have watched any sports in the last 10 years or so, if it's inconclusive, they stick with the call that was initially made.
And it's hard to tell here at Goggin because the only camera angle they're really able to look at on this is the main camera angle from high above center ice. They don't have those offside cameras like they do on the NHL that are right on the blue line, stationary, pointing at it. We're still getting a look here as we got one referee, one linesman are in there. They're both looking at the monitor, squinting at it, just trying to tell if it was an offside or not. As there's about 41 seconds, it appears, on the clock around the time of the St. Cloud zone entry. But if this is, in fact, an offside, then St. Cloud State would have to take away the game-winning goal from Luke Jaycox with 25.2 seconds to go in the third period. St. Cloud leading the shots 28-21 right now. We're able to look at the referee monitor from where we are, high above center ice here at Goggin, on the same side as the cameras, but you're in the booth next to us. And the referee's now looking at the corner angle. So there's a camera angle in the near corner of the Husky offensive zone from high above there. And they're looking at a zone entry that came on the left wing of the offensive zone for St. Cloud, so the opposite end of the ice from where that corner camera is in the St. Cloud offensive zone.
I think both teams getting pretty restless here on their respective benches, especially on the St. Cloud side. You see the players are
skating around
a bit.
Yeah, it's hard to tell because they're looking at basically a desktop computer monitor, and you got two referees there with helmets on trying to squint through it. You got very high camera angles. They're not zoomed in very far. You're trying to look at little players, little skate blades on a small blue line at that angle.
Yeah, and this would shock me if they overturned this at this point now, just because
of
how long this review's been. It's got to be so close that you got to think it might be too tough to tell where that puck actually was.
This review has got to be going on for at least 7 or 8 minutes now, don't you think?
Maybe it's just us in the booth, but it feels like it.
Still talking on the headset. There is no sign of them ending this review. It's now some players from each team just skating around their own ends, still on the bench.
I'm sure you remember from, was that last year, the review with a couple seconds left in the period. We're
going to
get the call here.
25.2 to go. If it's offside, no goal. Here's our call. It was onside, and the St. Cloud State Huskies lead this game by a score of 2-1 with 25.2 to go in the third. Well, Luke Jaycox for St. Cloud State will pick up his second goal of the year, just his third point of the year. And it might be the game winner tonight for the Huskies very late in the third. Rucks with a center ice draw. They get Grant Valentine off the ice very quickly with 18 to go in the third period. Puck back to the near side, neutral ice. Dashke wraps it around the boards to the far half. Wallace John, far corner for St. Cloud State, picks it up. Loose puck picked up by Green, walks it in. Left point Dashke, 7 seconds to go. Right point Gillick fired it in off a stick to the near half wall. Green picks it up. It comes out of the zone. 1 second to go. That does it. Gordy Green trying to feed there. Kashki at the left point, but he couldn't keep it in. The puck back to center, and by that time, the horn sounded. And so the St. Cloud State Huskies on a goal from Luke Jaycox, rather. That came with 25.2 seconds to go in the third period. We'll take game one of this two-game series tonight by a score of 2-1 over the Miami RedHawks.
And it's a great win for St. Cloud. You know, they've struggled a little bit earlier in the season, and you got to imagine they came into this series thinking that there was definitely a chance for a win, maybe even two wins for them. and wanted to get things rolling in conference action. And I thought they got outplayed by Miami, especially in that third period for a good portion of it. But to steal a game on the road like they did today is absolutely huge. And for Miami, it's got to be really disappointing to lose a game, especially a conference game. You know, after your last conference series was pretty, you know, the last two conference series were pretty solid.
Right.
And, you know, just one lapse for the RedHawks in the third period. And a really dangerous St. Cloud team with a lot of weapons cashes in. And the Huskies take game one of the series.
And they do so by a score of 2-1 over the Miami RedHawks. Tonight, St. Cloud won the shots battle as well, 28-21. So Luke Jaycox was the goal scorer for St. Cloud, the game winner that came 19:34 into the third period. It was Yanni Cronilla who got the first goal for St. Cloud State, 17-19 into the first, the lone goal scorer for Miami tonight. It was their one and only one that came 1:52 into the third period to tie the game at one. At that point, Casey Gilling scoring it for Miami, assisted by Karsh Bachman and Gordon Green. All right, Luke, so game two of this series will be tomorrow right back here on Red Hawk Radio, 7:05 Eastern Time. Your start here from Goggin Ice Center. What does Miami have to change real quick here as we wrap things up from Oxford tomorrow night?
Well, I think they got to come out a little bit harder. I think that, you know, they didn't end up really super paying the price for coming out as slow as they did, I thought. I thought that St. Cloud definitely could have extended this lead out, especially early in the game, a lot more than they did. But, you know, you really just don't give yourself much of a chance to win. They were lucky to get a chance to win today because of just how badly they got outplayed in the first period. But I really think that you just increase your chances so much if you're just able to come out firing. And I don't think they did that towards the third period. And, you know, while they were lucky enough to stay in this game, today may not be the same story tomorrow. So I think they just need to start a lot faster and, you know, not kind of ease into the game as they did tonight.
All right, we'll see if they're able to do that tomorrow night. Again, 7:05 Eastern right here on Red Hawk Radio. Luke and I back with you on the call for game two of this series between St. Cloud State and Miami. Huskies the winners tonight by a score of 2-1 over the Miami Red Hawks. For Luke West-Poley, this is Patrick Geshan. Take so long. A good night from Goggin Ice Center in Oxford, Ohio. Thank you so much for listening. We appreciate it. Again, back here 7:05 tomorrow night. This has been a presentation of Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Have a great night.